Okay, we're left.
Yo, it's your girl Big Show. You tuned in to the truth session. Don't get no realer than this.
Hey, it's Mellow Cool as fuck, and we checking in on Tuesday with the truth session with Big Show and Lacey Doll. Y'all already know what the fuck going on. Let's see what they drinking this week, because I'm always tuned in.
Yo, what's up, everybody?
I think I'm to get a bag, and I was driving with no tags. Still be dripping in my rags, and I don't stand for no flag. I'm a boss, make my own rules. Want the money, I can have a cool. I remember days, no food. Independence kinda turned me cruel. I drive through a red light. If you want my spikes, gotta fight. Too many things had to walk through the night. Took me a while just to find some light. Came along with on the underground. All my niggas going pound for pound. I'm resilient, I can last around. Save my life while I start making sound. Stay humble, rather up or down. See me smile, but you don't see me frown. Graduate without a cap and gown. Still to hit you with them birds and nouns. Consider my journey before you judge. I was solid and I did it good. I ain't never try to hold a grudge. Too focused, trying to count some dubs. Gotta do what they won't do it for you. If need be, then I can always show you. Move with love and I can still talk my shit. Mind your business, please get on my. Gotta check now, don't flex. Me and T's and Nacho, we the best. Stacking more cause I came from less. That's the history and you know the rest.
Lead your heart, guide your heart to follow. Ain't smart, your heart could be deceived. And really looking out for you, use you as a pawn or a king. The only color matter green. Treat your soldiers like a king. You the plug you need, you got a feel, need a meaning, loyalty.
Yo, 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 man, it's your girl Big Show. We got Lacey Dow in the building.
Hi, guys.
Yeah, shout out to Lacey Dow, man. What do you miss Lacey Dow? We saw Lacey Dow last weekend. And how much we missed her face, you know what I'm saying? Lacey Dow, she done ran off and got married on us, you know what I'm saying? So we got champagne mimosas up in this thing, and we celebrating the happy union between her and my homie, Freshie. So y'all make sure y'all congratulate them, you know, and y'all see them out here in these streets and everything like that. Today we got two very, very, very special guests coming through. Wear Papa, okay? Nice clothing brand. Y'all can follow them on Instagram at Wear Papa. That's WEARPOPA. And we got my big homie, Ace Boom Coon, sliding through this piece, man. If y'all don't know Ace, man, he's like an Atlanta legend. At least to me, he is like an Atlanta legend or whatnot. So if y'all ever heard the song, I want to say it was called like Fruity or Smell Like Fruity or something like that with Rick Ross and Young Dro, then that's the homie Ace, you know what I'm saying? So y'all make sure that y'all stay tuned in because the homie, he coming through, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I got to turn because we're going to have a guest.
I'm excited. Okay. The lights in them.
Gotcha. Sounds good. All right. So, hey, like I said, man, y'all already know how we do it. We got to pay these bills. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to play a little quick commercial for y'all. And then we're going to come back and we're going to get everything cracking. You did?
I spend a lot of time in the backyard. And I'm the center of attention at summer barbecues. In 96, I made some of the tastiest s'mores. And at 09, it was me, your backyard fire pit, that accidentally started a wildfire when the summer breeze carried one of my embers into some dry brush. Spark a change, not a wildfire. Visit SmokeyBear.com, brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
My name is Lola Sylvester, and I'm going to be 95 this year. I was very independent. I fell, and I had to have meals on wheels. America, let's do lunch.
One in six singers faces the threat of
hunger. Well, I mean, I'm not going to say we won't.
Drop off a hot meal and say a quick hello. Volunteer for Meals on Wheels by donating your lunch break at AmericaLet'sDoLunch.org. This message brought to you by Meals on Wheels America and the Ad Council.
Hey everyone, let's all stop what we're doing and take a moment. You see, every moment can be kind of special. But it can be a lot of moments, goofy moments, dorky moments, it doesn't matter. Because every time dad's like us, to the moment like
I like it better with the raspberry lemonade or like the blueberry lemonade, but they didn't have it. All they had was
so let's take a moment to make a moment. Call 877-49-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Okay. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, and the NDA.
Major shout out to our sponsor, Smooth Move Scene Relocation Services, your downsizing and relocation expert. Baseline, business above everything. It's members from the church club, goddess involved growth, your stylist and hair care extraordinaire. Get on her to get your hair done and for all those natural hair and body products. Evolution, your first ever LGBT beauty bar. In the cities. It's your roadmap to everything LGBTQ. You can download it in your app store. Crushing Visuals got your videography, your video treatments, and your photography on lock. All your visual needs, you need to make sure you holler at Crushing Visuals. Black Excellence Networking is a great way to discuss your ventures with like-minded individuals. Be on the lookout for all the networking events monthly. Amethyst Mood Healer, your spiritual guidance, crystals, oils, chakra kits, etc. You need to holler at her if you're looking to get your mind right and your spirit right. You can't forget Lady Love Designs. Get at her for any of your designing needs, t-shirts, mugs, etc. Promo materials. And don't forget Honey Orchid. She had all those body butters and oils and all those type of things for you as well. So make sure you holler at our sponsors. All that information can be found on our website, www.onblastradioatlanta.com.
Hey, so yeah, y'all make sure y'all check out our sponsors. Make sure y'all visit us on the web. If y'all didn't know, On Black Radio Atlanta, we up for an award, the I Sign Myself Awards. Y'all can find a link on our website. We just told y'all, but I'm going to tell you again, it's onblastradioatlanta.com. So make sure y'all go there. Well, if you want to go direct, it's onblastradio.com/contest. And you can go right there, click on the link, or click on the picture, and it's going to take you right there to go vote. Make sure you vote for On Blast Radio, and make sure you vote for my homie, Mellow Cool as Fuck. You know what I'm saying? We both best of the year, you know what I'm saying? So, see, best female artist, best internet station. So, y'all make sure y'all show us some support and go vote. And I'm talking about vote 100 times. We want to leave with a trophy. You can vote as many times as you like, so don't forget about little dogs, you know what I'm saying? Even if you're a big dog, you dig? Let's see here. Lacey, how was your, man, we ain't seen you in 2 weeks, so, you know, I'm just going ahead and give you the flow. You know, I give you the flow and you can tell everybody what you've been up to since you've been away from us.
I got married.
Yeah.
I moved. And I've taken a lot of time out to decorate my home. It was a process. And we decided to get married last Thursday, and got married on Saturday. And it worked out perfectly.
We just up and decided, like, hey, man, we're just going to go ahead and do this thing.
Mm-hmm. 2 a.m., drunk Lacey went into Freshie's office and said, let's just get married this weekend. And Freshie said, okay. And we applied for our license, went to the courthouse and got it. And then we reached out to somebody to marry us. And our families was like, hey, if y'all can make it, y'all can make it. If y'all can't make it, y'all can't make it. It's cool. And that was it. We got married on Saturday.
That's what's up. congratulations. You know what I'm saying? So you've had a lot going on. Work, marriage, you know, mm-hmm. Of course. All the other things that you do. All the wonderful other things that you do.
Have you been taking a break? I've been taking a break from just... Only thing I filmed is this reality show. And that's because I got to follow around. Other than that, I've just been focusing on getting my home together. Because, you know, it took us a month to move in.
Yeah.
Getting my home together.
Well, that's what's up, man.
What's been going on?
Well, I mean, you know, we had a couple guest hosts the past 2 weeks, and let me see, what's been going on in my life? I've been doing a lot of working. Like I said, you know, I got a big project that's going on right now. We got a contract, so I've been busy, you know, long days or whatnot, and, you know, just trying to reach out to more people so we can get more music for everybody on the station, and so we can get more business owners and more artists coming in to talk with us and everything like that, man. You know, me and Mello, we just been grinding.
You guys filed for an LLC.
We absolutely did. Together.
I love it.
Yeah, together. I mean, yeah, we did. Well, we filed for it a while ago or whatnot, but I wound up having to do some name changes for whatever reasons. And so we actually had just got it back like maybe a week or two ago or whatever. It's crazy. I'm glad I just went and looked because, you know, they just did the name change. They didn't give me an update. So I had to go back into my account and I saw like, oh, damn, like the shit already been whatever, processed or whatever like that. It had been like that's processed since like the 3rd of September, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, you know, hey man, me and Mello, big things. On Blast Media, you know, she has really stepped up with helping with everything, and I couldn't even think of any better person to have as my partner other than, you know, my best friend. So there it is.
She's gonna turn this place into a powerhouse. I love it.
I mean, 100, 100. You know what I'm saying? Like, the two of us together, ain't no stopping already. So, hey, everybody who's tuning in to Facebook, make sure you share in the feed and, you know, tell a friend to tell a friend and make sure they share the feed too. If you tune in on Live 365, we appreciate you, man. Keep them ears plugged in right here because it's going down in a major, major way. Like I said, we got two interviews today, one with Where Papa. He should be here somewhere around maybe like 8 o'clock or something like that. So y'all make sure y'all be on the lookout for that. And then my man Ace, he should be here any minute now. There's a whole lot going on in entertainment news around here. But one of the first things I want to talk about is like this Black Youngster and Young Dolph beef. So like the beef been going on for a while, and I guess it has something kind of sparked from like Yo Gotti, because Yo Gotti and Young Dolph had some beef or whatever, and you know Black Youngsters under Yo Gotti's label or whatnot, and I guess they say he put bullet holes or something. Well, it's allegedly he shot at Young Dolph's car and put bullet holes in his car. And then he also like went on some rampage about, you know, shooting him up or something like that. He like in some video like riding down the street like just shooting his gun or whatever the hell, you know what I'm saying? Talking about, yeah, you know, something about having, he better have, Dolph is gonna need shooters for his shooters or something like that, messing around with his crew. So
have you been to Memphis?
No, I haven't.
Okay, the beef is real. Like, when I used to live in Memphis, when I tell you the beef is real, it's real on, like, a hood and corporate level. Like, they buy billboards. Like, they have entire billboards where Yo Gotti is throwing shots at you. Like, Young Dolph, but, like, entire neighborhoods. There are entire neighborhoods that either, like, they can't go to, right? Like, the entire neighborhoods that protect one side or the other side. Like, it's crazy. Like, you'll see, like Young Dolph, like driving around in his Lamborghinis and shit in these like hood ass neighborhoods that really are his security. It's fucking crazy. So I'm not surprised that that would have happened because the beef is real in Memphis. Like even clubs, like some clubs won't play one people's music to play the other. It's crazy. Like there are strip clubs where if like one side goes to the strip club, they only play their music. They will never play the other music, and like the other can never come into that strip club. Like it gets so real. It's a real hood ass beef.
That's crazy. So let me correct myself, because he actually said, "Fucking with my gang gonna get your shooter shot," is what he said in his Instagram video that he posted publicly for everyone to see. And you know, there were shots fired, of course, but they say, you know, there weren't any injuries or anything. But as of yesterday, Black Youngster is in jail. He got arrested. He got arrested for having a firearm on him in Dallas while doing an illegal turn. Wow. And they found a handgun in between his legs.
Okay.
So, unfortunately, you know, he is on lockdown. And let's just hope the gun that he had in between his legs wasn't the gun that he was on Instagram firing off out into the street and everything like that, okay?
Well, you could be on Instagram firing if you don't hit nobody, you're good.
No, you can't be riding down a residential street firing a gun from a car. That's called,
endangering lives. Endangerment.
That's called a fucking drive-by. That's what it is. It's a shootout. That's a drive-by.
Real words for that?
I think that's illegal.
Hopefully the gun
he's on
his camera was a fake gun.
Well, fake guns don't make real sounds. So
in our police department, like, it gets real. When I tell you, when you're in Memphis, you gotta be this side or that side. And the way that, like, you know, for like the rest of us, the Democratic and Republican Party can really split our friends. This beef can split, like, really split up friends. It really is.
That's crazy. Hey, look, y'all. Hey, look, man. A Big Show plan on coming to Memphis. Look, y'all ain't got no beef with nobody. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm cool with everyone. You know what I'm saying? If you're upset that I'm cool with the other side, you should probably just kind of reconstruct your mind frame and figure that out. You can see counseling. Okay? You know what I'm saying? Because I listen to all types of music.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't think that violence is the answer for whatever is going on. You know what I'm saying? Like, resort back to the music. You feel me? Go back to the music, talk shit or whatever like that. Not about killing each other or shooting or beating up or nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? Just have some friendly battle words or something. I don't know. Okay. You know, but violence is definitely not it.
It started off friendly, but then what happened was Dolph started getting more airplay. And
well, I mean, we can't help that. If people like Dolph, and they just like Dolph. I mean, like, that's ridiculous. You know what's crazy? Again, if you mad at somebody because they successful, you need to restructure your thinking and you need some help. You know what I'm saying? Like, you need to go figure yourself out. Or maybe you need a Rhymer's Dictionary and a thesaurus. And then you can, I mean, but I'm just saying, that'll make you better. It'll make you better. That's all I'm saying. Like, if you beefing up with somebody because I got better rhymes than you, then my man, go study. It don't take that much. You know what I'm saying? Go put some words together and fire them. And there it is.
Shots.
I mean, I'm just saying, you can't hate on somebody because they got more talent than you, or because they shit taking off quicker than you.
They're more popular than you.
Okay, that's true. Or more popular than you. You can't hate on that. You know what I'm saying? Get out there and meet some people. Shake some hands and kiss some babies, okay? Moving on. I mean, I'm just saying. I'm just saying, that's what makes people like people,
the
right?
The words spoken on this radio show do not reflect the views of me.
The words spoken on this radio show are truly opinions of people, you know what I'm saying? And everyone is free to have their own opinion. Don't take anything literally. Don't go out and restructure your life based on that. You know what I'm saying? That's something internal that you should do internally, okay? So you figure that out if that's what's for you or not. You know what I'm saying? I'm not telling anybody to do anything. My suggestion is only a suggestion, and it make a whole lot of sense. So, the LAPD is investigating Dr. Dre's estranged wife, Nicole Young, over her alleged embezzlement of funds, over $300,000.
Yeah.
So the LAPD, they're taking it seriously, and they're actually looking into that. So, Nicole Young, man, get the money back, or, you know what I'm saying? I don't know what it is.
Right here.
Or why you signing all that type of money out of somebody else's account.
You know why she did it?
During a divorce. Yeah, of course, because
prior to divorce, and during the divorce, because she was afraid she wouldn't get anything. But you know
what? She signed a prenup. Of course she wouldn't get anything.
But a lot of spouses, a lot of wealthy spouses do this, though. They'll start to move money around. It is illegal. Okay. It is investment.
But if you're taking it from a business, then it's illegal.
Isn't it crazy?
You need to figure that out.
Girl, take it from his actual
account. I mean, I'm saying, they not have any
joint.
Look, and if you've been married for this man for however long y'all been married, and it's been a minute, and y'all don't have a joint account, baby, you should have left him a long time ago.
A lot of these women get married when they're young to really controlling, not in a sense of like controlling a relationship, but controlling of life. Like, alpha men like to be in control of their situations. That's how you get to where he's at.
Well, you know what happened to Michelle Olay.
Michelle Olay.
Y'all.
Squirrel boys.
Okay. Okay, y'all saw the movie.
You find a way, your life to these guys, and bam, now it's 40 years later, 20 years later, 30 years later, and you realize this ain't where I want to be, and you got nowhere to go.
She got plenty of places to go. She was married to Dr. Dre. She got some pull. She done met some people along the way, and if she didn't, again, her bad. That's her
she
bad.
Did, but if your partner is in control of who you meet, sometimes it could hinder you. So I think her fear was that she wouldn't be able to live the lifestyle that she was accustomed to after she lived with him. And honestly, I'm not going to lie, I feel like this. If in your life you did not ensure as an individual that you had it in
secure the bag,
that is your fault.
And I'm sorry. If I was married and I knew I signed a prenup, every time I was able to go into that account, I took off a little bit and I would put it away in another account. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, just in case. It's my little throwaway money. Every time he came and dropped a couple stacks on me, like, baby, go shopping or whatever. Like, that. Guess what? I would took a little bit. I would put it away to the side so that I made sure I had me a nice little cushion, because guess what? My stupid ass signed a prenup.
Or started your own business somewhere in between.
I mean, I'm saying that. She definitely could. But I don't know. You know, because like you said, if somebody got they paws and they claws all in you like that, then he may have had control of whether she could do whatever. You know what I'm saying?
And but the best in way to himself.
Nobody can stop you from hopping online to your government agency and filing an LLC on your own personal time, okay?
Damn.
It costs about less than $200. I mean, in Georgia, it costs $100. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, really.
Less than $200.
You have to think, people. So now that we see these things, you know, y'all see these things going on, these things happening in the media, man, you know, like, they put all them people's business out in the open. I hope y'all learning lessons from that and y'all paying attention to what's going on.
Do you think that maybe it wouldn't have been such a big issue if she hadn't requested such a large amount of money after her divorce? She was getting crazy.
I mean, I don't know how much money she asked for.
Oh, my.
But listen, man, I don't know Dre. What I do know is whatever the stories of whatever his past relationships have been. And if I would have gotten myself in that type of situation and locked down in that type of situation, then I just would have thought a little better. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't think she, like, don't deserve nothing. But And unfortunately, I don't know how long they were married.
A long
time. But if they, okay, so since they've been married since the 90s, they've been married about 30 years. Okay, so if they've been married for about 30 years, then I would think that he should respect a woman who's been with him 30 years and had not had a career, in most cases because he didn't want her to, that he would set her up to at least be okay. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, Dre got stupid dumb money. Okay.
Yeah, it was like her request was so fucking crazy.
I mean,
what was she demanding? It was something like $3 million just for entertainment for a month or something. Entertainment.
Oh, no. That's
like
ridiculous.
The breakdown was crazy. I was like,
that's ridiculous. I mean, but once you get accustomed to a certain type of lifestyle, then I mean, you know, he set her up to want that and to need.
Well, as his spouse, not some hoe that he wasn't with no more.
I mean, she spent 30 years with that nigga.
She should
That's
have
a
made
job.
Sure she was taken care of.
She should have, but still, you know, if I spent 30 years of my life with somebody, you know, I would make sure they were straight. I wouldn't break my bank account or nothing like
what
that.
She was
you know, but I can
think for her.
And she's ridiculous, and that's why she lost. And unfortunately, mm-hmm. you know, you don't get shit, and then you might catch a case for embezzlement. Just fucked up.
See?
Okay? It is.
Lessons learned, lady. Take it from his personal account out to business account.
Get a joint account. You know what I'm saying? Well, be smart, man. Save some money. Because she had access to a lot of money. You know, over
years.
The years, oh, 30 years, she's had access to a lot of money.
Yeah.
She should have. Just, I mean, any woman, you always want to feel safe. I mean, or, you know, secure. You need to make sure that that your shit is together. You have to. You know what I'm saying? Because any person could just leave you like that. Any relationship is not guaranteed. It's just not, unfortunately. You know what I'm saying? So I would just, you know, be careful. Know your partner. You know what I'm saying? And pay attention to when things change, because I don't know who filed for the divorce, but it was a change before that divorce happened.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So pay attention to the signs. You feel me?
Yeah.
That's for sure. So a former Major League Baseball player, Tommy Pham, was stabbed outside of a strip club. And he was just, I guess he was like confronting people who were kind of arguing, like right near his car, while he was trying to
get to his car.
I want to say it was Memphis, I think.
Athletes get stabbed too.
Yeah, athletes get stabbed too. They do. And he was just trying to get people away from his car arguing. That's crazy. But they said a whole like fight broke out and stuff like that. Like my man, he was gashed from like up here to like down to like his waistside or whatever. Like the video had like blood and all that stuff just like dripping off his shirt. But they say he's going to be fine. He's going to be fine. He played for the Cardinals and he played for the Padres, if y'all don't know who
the Padres is terrible
or whatever. And man, you know, baseball is kind of terrible. But,
but baseball is
good. I watch it when I'm bored.
Crazy money.
They do. I watch it when I'm bored. That's all I'm saying. If I'm bored and there's nothing on TV, I will watch baseball.
How? I went to a Cardinals. I went to a Padres game. I was sitting on the floor or whatever, wherever it is. I left. I left. I couldn't do it. Somebody said, you know, no. You gotta drink the beer. You gotta get drunk. And then it becomes interesting. I tried to drink a beer. I said, I'm about to go to a lounge. This is too much.
I went to an Atlanta game. And I think they were playing the Tigers. And I mean, it's a whole lot more fun at the game, not watching it on TV. When I'm watching it on TV, it's very, very boring. But that's why I say when I'm bored, and nothing is on TV, I watch it. But in person, it was exciting. I was excited to be there. It was lit. Yeah. I mean, it was a bunch of people. It's downtown Atlanta. You know what I'm saying? It was turned up. I mean, for me, it was great because, you know, I live in Atlanta. It was the Detroit Tigers. I'm from Detroit. So, like, it was just lit to me.
I lived in San Diego. I left the Padres. I left. Like, but, you know, also, I'm not a sports kind of girl. I told you guys what happened when I went to that professional football game. And I thought the little lines were really on the floor. They're not. They're just on TV. I said, what is the hype? Your girl got to go. I'm hungry. Like, you guys, I left. Oh, that sucks for him, though, that literally, like, I'm just trying to go home.
I mean, you know what I'm saying?
And I go to the hospital.
After having a good time, just trying to get to the crib, you know what I'm saying? Seeing the little booty. That's fucked up. You know what I'm saying? That's fucked up. That's real messed up. For real, for real.
But so, maybe, what if he said something crazy to get them away from his car?
I mean, wouldn't you have said something a little crazy to get arguing people away from your car?
I'm a female. I'm a very female one. I would have had to approach that a little bit different because, you know,
you left the strip club. You were probably drunk. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Or somewhere close to it.
What if he caught them poor motherfuckers?
You broke bitches. Get the fuck away from my car.
Like, that's crazy.
Right. Yeah, right, man. Get the fuck up off my shit. Man, that's a robbery. You know what I'm saying? No. I don't. No. Yeah. For real. I already fucked that nigga up out there. Clearly. You know what I'm saying? But they said like a whole brawl broke out. Like it was like a couple fights like after the whole scenario or whatever. So man, just shout out to Tommy because hey, they said he gonna be all right. He gonna make it, you know, and his team is behind him and everything like that. They said he gonna make a full recovery. So that's what's up. Now what we gonna do is, of course, man, the bills gotta be paid. I'm gonna play another commercial. I'm gonna play another song. And we gonna come back with a little bit more news. Like I said, we got Where Papa coming up a little bit after 8. My man Ace is supposed to be pushing up. And he might come out to 8 too, because like I said, man, I had some switcheroo around plans because of work. So, like I said, man, hopefully we have our guests here after 8. Y'all can go ahead, keep sharing the feed, tell a friend, and tell some more friends. Okay.
All right.
Hey,
man,
we all can be friends.
Dear John.
Dear John.
Home.
That's
really
the first thing I read. I think you heard that one.
You know me as a race car driver, but I'm also a Meals on Wheels volunteer. I've raced against the sports biggest personalities. But I've never met more vibrant, amazing people than the senior served by Meals on Wheels. You can make a difference by dropping off a hot meal
and saying it's picking up.
So, America, let's do lunch. Volunteer your lunch break. And America, let's do lunch.
We've all been saying to your friend, get a different face. And posting that game. It's a little
different.
It's a little different.
I like
Add in the
Brand a little bit of orange juice and
Learn more at eyewitnessbullying.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council.
Hope you enjoyed your meal.
Oh my God.
And I just want to say, he's lucky to have a brother like you.
I haven't been live in so long.
Lucky. Caring for my brother is far from easy.
About,
he's a part of me.
What do you guys
like
think
my arms and legs, so I'll be his. No time for tired. Nothing can disable this love. He needs me. But I'm
if
lucky.
Memphis,
even
I would
though
never,
I need help right now.
If you're caring for a loved one, visit AARP.org/caregiving for care guides and community. Support for your strength. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
What do you guys think about Nicole too? Like, do you guys think she was just asking for too much, and then she let too much information out about her, and now Dre's people are like, "Hey, Popo, get this bitch. You tried to rob me.
This whole trying to rob me. You want all my money?
You want all of his money? Like all of his money." What do you need millions of dollars a month for entertainment?
Social media, you know what I'm saying? Like, come on now. That's why I think people are so narrow. Okay. So, I got something that we can talk about. A little topic. Right until the people get here. We got more news, but why do we think so everything on social media? So, I just saw a movie this weekend about these bank robbers. I think it was on Netflix. About these bank robbers. It was a girl and her boyfriend. And they, like, wanted to be famous or whatever. Like, the girl wanted to be famous. So, her boyfriend went to jail for robbery, and, you know, they had, you know, ownership, you know, they from wherever, dad beating on the son, the girl had to save him, like, all of her money to get the hell away from where her mother's boyfriend stole her money or whatever, so her boyfriend died, and they just don't leave, right? They couldn't even start robbing him.
Thank you.
Check them out. Y'all, of course, can find them on Old Blast Radio Atlanta. We are on Live 365, so you can search from Live365.com on Blast Radio Atlanta, and you'll find us. The links are all over the web. We don't say they're everywhere. Or you can go right to OnBlastRadioAtlanta.com, and there is a little button that you can click, and it's going to take you right to where you need to go to hear all the hottest music. It's a link. If you scroll down further, that'll take you right where you need to go if you want to watch our video feed. So I want to thank everybody who's tuned in now. I want to thank everybody who's been sharing our live, and we're going to get back into some of this news. Oh, so my question that I posed while we were listening to music was, why is it that this generation feel like they have to put everything on social media? If you have a thought, opinion about that, of course, give us a call, 678-777-4583. And we'll be right here by the line waiting on you. You know what I'm saying? But moving into a little bit more news, I mean, you got the list. You want to talk about what's next? You know, give you a little...
This is what I think is crazy.
What's going on, Angel?
I think it's a little crazy that Joe Biden's campaign recruited battle rappers Charlie Clip and DNA out of New York in an ad for pros and cons of voting. What?
Hey, look, did you? Oh, but wait, did you see the strippers in Atlanta who had the video that said it's oh man, what is it? Something to pose. It's like get to the pose, and they like all like coming down the pole, and they talking about, but now let me tell you, at first I was like, wow, but then, like, they actually took the time to break down the different parts of, you know, the government, and whatever like that, and why it's important to vote, and all these girls, they all intelligent, and stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? I mean, but don't get me wrong, because I know a lot of dancers, they go to school, and they do I mean, don't get me wrong, some of them don't, they just want to be strippers, it just kind of showed a different side, but stripped to the polls or something like that. Like, it was funny, but it just so happened that I do have the clip of this battle rap, and what I was going to do is, I don't think I can play it from there with the sound. So I was going to play it so that everyone can hear it.
Oh my gosh, I'm so nervous.
You're so nervous.
I get the point, because you want to appeal to the the younger generations, and right now everything happens to be black. So black media, rap, style, culture, you're going to appeal to the entire range of Gen Xers or Gen Zers. But Joe Biden, bro, here's my thing with politicians. You can't choose to use black people when you're going for office, but not any other time. Where was this when you were just a regular, regular, schmegular dude on the street?
Hey, look, I think they are pulling out, like, really all the stops when it comes to this whole voting thing. Like, they're taking social media to a whole new level. Like, when I'm sitting and I'm listening, because I'm on YouTube all the time. So when I'm sitting and I'm listening to these YouTube videos and stuff like that, like, all the little ads in between there is like, something about the office, right. Something about going and voting. John Ossoff. I done seen John Ossoff so many doggone times. I'm about to lose my mind.
The real news, you know what I'm saying? This guy. Who is John Ossoff?
I mean, no. But look, what's crazy is everybody is talking bad about him. But what's the lady who ran for governor? What was her name here?
Oh, Stacey Abrams.
Stacey Abrams is backing John Ossoff, okay? So she says that we should vote for John Ossoff because she believes that he is going to help with the school system and help us not have to pay for college. So, or reduce student loans or something to that capacity or whatever. So she has endorsed John Ossoff. But let me tell y'all, I didn't heard of, but you know, and look, and let me say, I'm not into politics, but I watched this commercial. I told you, they keep playing the little clips in the YouTube. So one of these things, it talk about, it just bust in how he, they said how he be talking violent, something about beating somebody to that black and blue or something like that. Now this is, that's what he was saying, but they cut the clip. Like you can tell that they cut the clip like from a longer conversation or something like that. So who knows what he was actually talking about to his comrades or whatever like that. But how they cut the clip made it seem like he was talking about beating people black and blue or something like that. So I mean, I you know, man, politics is so underhanded and they just be slinging. Yeah, I mean it's ridiculous. But anyways, I got this clip of this battle with Charlie Clips and DNA. You know what I'm saying? So we're gonna go ahead and we'll play that.
I do like these guys a lot.
It's crazy.
Oh yeah, and I'm sorry, man. I wanted to show it on a big screen, but the sound don't run through from here or whatnot. But they like kind of texting back and forth about meeting up at the basketball court or something. You know, my man Charlie is at the basketball court shooting hoops.
I love the supposed to be
voting. So y'all just get that a little second. But I'm interested in seeing how.
Yo, why you ain't been answering your phone? You know why I'm calling you. You have to vote. You know why I don't vote? Because as a black man, I just feel like there's no hope. Our president telling people to go back to China, taking the coronavirus as a joke. And that's the part that frightened me. When you choose a president, it's supposed to be a knockout. Then why this situation doesn't entice me? If you got the answers to get me out this dark path, my brother, enlighten me. We always telling each other to stay woke. That's why this time we gotta use our voice and you have to vote. The facts should show. Biden has a plan for African Americans. We're not dealing with your average Joe. I see the way you're looking right now. You know exactly where I'm gonna go with this. For 4 years we had Trump in office and we made the most of it. But we finally got somebody that could be in office that could give us a chance to have home ownership. I'm talking to all of you. $640 billion over the course of 10 years so we could finally get housing that's affordable. Look at him now. I got him stuck. With Biden and Harris' plan, we got to trust. Because we can't say we support Obamacare, but rock with Trump.
So Harris and Biden is going to help with black ownership, huh?
No.
Okay. Maybe it's true. But what about the black colleges and all the funding for the HBCUs? Is Biden going to follow in Obama's footsteps and go all out with health care? Or is he going to laugh at us like our president now while our people struggle on welfare? You see, I did my research. Which is exactly why I could rebuttal that. Biden and Harris planning to put $70 billion to the HBCU. We're not just talking about a couple racks. Giving teachers a raise. What Trump attempted to do, they plan to double that. And as far as the rich and poor with schools, the whole goal is to end the funding gap.
That sounds legit. Only if our president now would quit.
Hey, did you know that unemployment for African Americans is up this year 20%? So when you tell me to go and vote, but the reason why it's such a hard one, because how we expect our people to get jobs, and the president can't even get the job done.
Bro, I understand it's a process, so I'm not rushing you. Take your time. You know what, speaking of that, I got the perfect place to take you that'll change your mind.
No,
I'm
good. I'm already going.
So you think because you brought me here that I'm just supposed to confide in Biden? What about the innocent blacks that get snatched out their vehicles just for riding? We don't even ask for much. All we do is ask for respect. Before they did what they did to George Floyd, this country had their foot on our neck. Now do you understand why I'm upset?
I feel you. Because every time we throw the system an uppercut, or they give us in return, it's low blows. But Biden and Harris got a plan to outlaw the chokehold. It's inspiring. Donald Trump is the apprentice, but now it's our turn to do the firing. And review everything. Listen, let's see them before we hire them. Breonna Taylor, George Floyd, Eric Garner, Trayvon Martin,
Say their damn names. The goal is to get Donald out of office and Trump his campaign. You know, before you actually called my phone, I honestly had no hope. But if Biden and Harris going to do exactly what you said, then I'm going to go vote.
All right. Paid for by Biden.
Of course it was.
For president.
Okay. Of course it was.
You guys. Of course it was. Biden and Harris. All right.
Can I?
You please. Please. Please.
I just think it's kind of crazy how Democrats focus solely on the poor, struggling African American. And I think it's crazy how Kamala, who this week maybe wants to be black and maybe next week wants to be her actual race, keeps like preaching to African Americans.
Which
like,
is? What is she?
Indian.
Oh, okay.
Like, she's so great when look at her track record. I'm not saying y'all should not vote for her. Vote for who you want to vote for. But also think real hard about who these different parties are preaching to. Trump and his party, they are going for the ignorant Caucasian, right? Because guess who shows up? The ignorant Caucasian. And Biden and Kamala are focusing on the emotions. They're pulling the emotional string, which is what Democrats do every 4 years. But where do they be in between that? I don't know. They're going to pull at the black, poor Americans' hearts every single time. Is Kamala or Biden kissing these babies and hugging these mothers' hands?
From my understanding, they didn't put a lot of us in jail.
Exactly. Combined. And even separate.
They locked us up.
Right? So it's like,
pull away the key.
You guys, this is cool or whatever. You know, it's so cute that you want to get the younger generations to vote. Every single term, everybody wants to get the younger generations to vote, right? Every single term. It never fails. So don't think that you're special because they're focused on Gen X now. Because they do this every 4 years. I remember when I was in high school and they were trying to, like, their Obama was fishing hard and I did vote for Obama. But it's like, make sure that you guys do actual real research, you know, getting these battle rappers to say your little points is cute.
Or the strippers.
Or the strippers, right? Or the Caucasian people that Trump is pushing his campaign towards, the police officers, the young service members, right? Make sure that you guys are doing your own real actual research before Absolutely. You go out and vote, because what you could end up doing is voting for somebody who's absolutely 100% against your needs and your interests, and all they're doing is appealing to what society is telling them they need to appeal to, Kamala, and or what that specific demographic is appealing to right now. So really, do your research. But voting is important because we do shape our lives if we get out there or if we don't get out there.
I mean, so yes. But, so I pose this question. What do you do when you don't like what any of these motherfuckers is saying?
So.
But they say, you still need to go and vote because, you know, our people fought and died and dot, dot, dot. I mean, you know, and that's not making it small, but I'm saying they did all these things for us to vote, but no candidate, you know, makes me want to just go rush and vote for them.
Yeah, I won't tell you guys who I voted for last time because I'm blacking out and I hate me. But I would say, think about what your actual, because, you know, it's like, let's use Trump and Hillary, because that election is over. That shouldn't offend anybody, yeah, or I'm not going to talk about anybody's current anything.
100.
One of the things that Hillary, you know, super focused on was the mothers of the slain kids, right? She focused really hard on being there for the mothers of dot, 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 dot. I did not agree with any of Hillary's political anythings. I did not. So to this day, I don't. But I was gay, and I'm a woman, and I was engaged to a gay female service member. And one of the things that Donald Trump said that he was going to do was repeal all of Obama's efforts, right? Any executive order Obama signed, Trump was going to repeal. And at the time, for me and my interest, an executive order that Obama signed was to legalize gay marriage nationally and to make it recognizable in the military. Because when I was active, if you were married to somebody of your same sex, you could get benefits, but they would not be marriage benefits. They would be single E6 benefits, right? As a civilian, that's not something that you would have ever had to worry about. But for me, my household was being provided by a service member. I'm a veteran. So my interests at the time were like, I need to think about me and my livelihood. And it might sound selfish, right? Because one of the other things that DT did back then was mock Muslims. And he mocked somebody that was disabled. He did a lot of things, right? He's a bully. Mm-hmm. I can't focus on y'all when my household needs my attention.
Right.
Right? And I talked to some other people that did vote for Donald Trump because I cried. I cried the day after he was elected because I thought, whoa, I can never be comfortable now in my life. And I lived in a mainly upper class Caucasian community, right? So I was afraid for being in my own neighborhood, in my own home. I stopped going for runs, for jogs, working out in my own neighborhood. I stopped. I didn't do it daytime, evening, night. I wouldn't do it anymore, right? I was worried for myself. And I cried, and I talked to a lady who worked at the clinic I worked in, and she said, she came to my office, you know, and everybody knows gay. They know I'm black, they know I'm young, you know, whatever. And she closed the door, and she said, I'm sorry for how my vote may affect you and yours, but I needed to vote in my interest. At the time, she was married to a wealthier man, and they paid less in taxes, and they were worried about their actual home and being able to afford their home. If Hillary had been voting into office, they would have lost thousands of dollars a year. Thousands. They had kids in college. They had a vacation home. They had a regular home, and then they were still helping their kids pay for the things that they had.
They should have sold one of their houses anyways.
Right, but you gotta vote for your, you have to vote for your interests, whatever your interests be. You really can't worry about what someone else is doing in their home, as selfish as it sounds, but you do have to worry about your own interests. And sometimes the person who wins isn't the person who you wanted.
That's true.
I survived.
We all survived.
A lot Trump, of service members survived. So if you're going to vote for Trump or Biden in this election, just understand that you will survive.
I voted for Hillary because she was married to Bill, and when Bill Clinton was in office, it was like, man, back home it was lit. When Bill was in office, man, you know, shit was straight. You know what I'm saying? So, hey, my thought process was just like, hey, look.
Did you do research on Bill afterwards?
Hey, guess what? I didn't do research on nobody because I'm not political. You know what I'm saying? And my thought process on what's going on, fam. We got wear pop up in the building. But no, my thought process when it comes to politics, first off, is, I mean, locally I care more so than the presidential elections. But yeah, the presidential election don't mean shit to me because the president has never elected. I mean, has never directly affected me in my household. Right. So I, whatever, whoever the president is, hey, whatever, that's our president, is how I feel about it. But I mean, I know with other people it's a little bit more important. Or whatnot. I'm more concerned about the laws and the things that's going on right around me where I live right at, and what's going on here, you know, why I'm getting pulled over for whatever reason, or why, you know, this law is that way and that way, dot, dot, dot.
Before we go to our interview, how do you feel about the fact that people keep talking about Breonna Taylor, George Floyd, et cetera, all lives that get lost locally, and they try to say that the president that you vote for affects the laws that protect them?
That's not true.
Right.
It's not true. The president does not dictate what is going on in your community. You know what I'm saying? Not directly.
Right.
And definitely not directly. So if that's what you're thinking, then yeah, you do need to go do your research and figure out who you need to be voting for your local government and the things that's going on around you and near your home and in your town, because each county is different. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Everybody got a different mayor. You know what I'm saying? You know, yeah, every state got a right. There's your sheriff. Every state got a governor. You know what I'm saying? Like, so learn the legislation and shit. You know what I'm saying? Go
Make sure that you guys are voting properly for your local elections, because the president is not the end all. He can't save all of us.
And make sure you're paying attention as well, because, you know, they don't tell us. They say it, but that election is not as popular as, like, the presidential election and stuff like that. And it don't happen at the same time as the presidential election. So you got to keep up with what's going on in your community and watch the news and listen to the radio and whatever like that, so that you can get out here and vote when it's time to do it for your local government.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? See, that's what my homie... The homie Scribble said life was carefree when Bill was in the house. It was. I mean, I'm just saying, no, not necessarily. Man, the grown-ups around me was living carefree too.
Yeah, but
okay.
I said this to my parents. Y'all were ignorant as fuck, because Bill Clinton imposed some of the harshest laws against minorities, Black and Mexican. So when you guys are like, "Oh, life was,"
it didn't touch my hood.
It did.
It didn't touch my hood.
It actually did.
Maybe
three
not till later on.
Three strike laws?
Hey, don't make a shit.
Who was the president?
I mean,
right? So it's like,
okay, but
super predators, the idea of super predators.
You know what I mean? But what
the
I'm
idea
saying,
of super predators, who was the president? Bill Clinton, right? So it's like, he did affect our lives immediately. He did. He actually did. But when Bill was in office, we were kids, we were younger, and life was carefree, period. It really didn't matter who the president was at that time, but if you're an adult, and depending on the neighborhood you lived in, Bill Clinton fucked you. He fucked you hard. And Hillary, when she was running, you know, one of the things that she kept trying to do was separate herself from her husband and his politics. She was hard. I'm not my husband, I'm not his politics. But if you even went back and looked at her history, her politics are even worse. Even worse, right? She too could have affected you, like right there immediately. But it was that we were younger.
But you still voted for her.
I didn't vote for Bill Clinton. I was a kid.
No, I said Hillary. You just said you voted for Hillary.
No, I didn't.
You said she was the person who was going to impose the things that dealt with your military.
I said I want to tell y'all who I voted for, because I'm Black and y'all gonna get mad.
Oh. Okay. Well, maybe she voted for Trump then. You know what? Actually, listen to me. When Trump got in office, you know what I thought? I was like, you know, maybe he'll do something good. He is a businessman. The United States ain't shit but a business. Let's see how it goes. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's how I considered or whatever. But I mean, to be honest with you, bruh, who gonna get up in there and make some big ass change that's really gonna do whatever the fuck? I say we get rid of presidents and we all just agree to be good. Ain't that? Then y'all see the post? Then y'all see the post? You know what I'm saying? So I say fuck the presidency. We don't need the presidency. We can keep all the rest of the government, so whatever like that. Like everybody else, you know what I'm saying? They can still have their titles and all that other stuff. We can keep the Congress and all that other stuff, you know what I'm saying? Whatever. They can make the laws and do whatever. But do we really need a president? Do we?
I
mean, I'm just saying, we'll just agree to be good. You know what I'm saying? You know,
the little thing you cut your hands and you put them
together. I mean, and I promise you, everybody would cut their fucking hand and shake hands. We'd have a whole motherfucking, the whole world would be together. You know what I'm saying? Y'all see them videos, they got all the people like around the globe and shaking everybody hand in hand and all that. Y'all seen that shit? You seen Us or whatever the fuck? Yeah, okay. Nigga, across the globe, across the land. You know what I'm saying? For real. We all just agree to be good. We're gonna be good. We'll do better, I promise. You know what I'm saying? Get that nigga up out of here. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna be good. We're gonna be good.
You know what DT talked about? People. He talked about creating another term for presidents, or getting rid of terms altogether. He's working on, in his next term, getting rid of terms altogether.
The motherfucking term should be shorter. Goddamn, you can't stick around this long.
Four
you
years?
Ain't married. I mean, that's a long ass time.
I've been in high school for 4 years, and that was a long time.
Look, man, it was a long time.
Congress and our Supreme Court, they definitely need to like have terms. You shouldn't be able to be in the Supreme Court for 40 years.
No. I don't think so either. I mean, and then you know what happens is the fact that, you know, a lot of people don't vote. It keep a lot of the people who've been keeping us suppressed and keeping our lives fucked up and shit like that in office anyway. They just roll right on over into the next term or whatever like that. Old as dirt, you know what I'm saying? You're sitting there making decisions and things have changed. You know what I'm saying? The world that we live in has changed or whatnot. And what we do, we need more young people to get out and run for office though too. You know, we need more young people to get into politics. And I mean, I think we do have a lot more people who are interested in going. I can't wait till my cousin runs for office. My cousin is running for office real soon. Sometimes I can get her up out here.
Did you see that DT doesn't know how much a gallon of milk is?
Somebody asked him,
he has no idea.
I don't know how much a gallon of milk is. I don't drink it though.
I drink almond milk, and I know how much almond milk costs.
I mean, I don't either. When I go to the store, if I want it, I'm just going to get it. I'll get whichever it fits.
Right, but you know it's not going to be like $50.
No, I do know it's not
going to be $50. You know it's not $1.
It's going to be like maybe
$3. Right, he had no idea.
$1.99 to $4, depending on what kind of milk you like. You know what I'm saying? I mean, because he don't go to the damn grocery store. We have people to do that for him.
But people should, you should be aware of
What everybody else is paying. Man, let me tell you something. I went to the store and they wanted $1.89 for a 20-ounce soda. That shit pissed me off. I didn't buy the fucking soda. I was like, hell no, man, I'm not paying that. I can go get a 2-liter. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can straight go get a 2-liter from the grocery store and I'm going to pay that same $1.89. You know what I'm saying?
It's a sugar tax. So if you buy a 2-liter, it's supposed to feed a family. If you buy a regular small, 1-liter or whatever soda, I don't drink soda, but they're going to charge you more on tax because that's enough for one person, just like a candy bar.
But that's not even a tax. Yes, it comes out $1.89 and then they put the tax on top of it. That's why I want to go back to Detroit.
It's the sugar tax on the drink. So the makers who buy the sugar have to pay extra for the sugar for that drink.
Man, change your sugar, bro. We don't need that. Use stevia or some shit, bro. I don't know, but bro, get that together. That's ridiculous. Okay. You can slide up. We got my man wear popping.
All the fun stuff.
Sit on food. Slide on in with us, you know what I'm saying? Down with the team, down with the team. We're gonna get his mic on. Cause we got him up first, but I got my man Ace Boom Coon in the building too. He out in the lobby, so man, everything like I said is kind of flowing just how it's supposed to be flowing. And we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get it started with my man before we do that. We should probably play a commercial. We're going to get a lot of talking, huh? So we're going to play a quick commercial. And when we come back, we're going to be with Wear Papa. He got a clothing brand that he's going to talk to us about. So y'all stay tuned. Oh, yeah. Go share that live feed right now. Go share it. We'll be right back.
Allison is perfect. I mean, she'd never tell you that.
Oh, okay.
She's humble and
she always
perfect.
Does. How's it going? She likes
everything.
Right. What's it going?
Let's
go.
And I don't
want
to have to
keep
on
texting or driving. Allison, no,
I got you. I got some stuff going on for you.
I was just saying about you. Why, Allison? Why?
Oh, my goodness. It's a box. Good luck. Oh, it's
official.
Oh, my God. Okay, look, I'm going to let Lacey open that. You know what I'm saying?
With the presentation.
I'm Paul George of the Indiana Pacers.
I'll let Lacey open.
When I was 6, my days were spent playing basketball. When I was 6, my dream was to make it to the NBA. When I was 6, my mom had a stroke. So I want you to learn to spot a stroke fast. F-A-S-T. F, face treatment. A, Army. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911. I'm Paul George. Spot a stroke fast. Visit strokeassociation.org. Brought to you by the American Stroke Association and the Ad Council.
My name is Lola Silvestri, and I'm going to be 95 this year. I was very independent. I fell, and I had
to even said life was carefree with them in the place. You know what I'm saying? They knew life was okay, I don't care if I was a kid or not. My cousin, my mama, my people, they was getting money. You don't know what you're talking about. Maybe not the young kids in my time. I was in Detroit, man. I'm going down around that motherfucker. Like, for real, it was going down. All right. For real.
Breaking news. Peace.
We let Lacey use the bathroom. play a little music or whatnot. This Lacey Live feed. So what's going on, everybody? They say congratulations to Lacey Gall and Freshie. Lacey and Freshie got married this weekend, so we celebrating. I don't have any more treats, but if you would like some champagne, mimosas, and we got some grab your man's cup. This is a styrofoam cup.
Wait a minute.
In the kitchen on top of the refrigerator.
All right, y'all.
Freshie's marriage. They got married this weekend, so congratulations to them. If y'all missed it, all right, if y'all missed that, everybody missed it, if y'all just tuned in, they got married this weekend, so I decided that, yo, man, champagne mimosas was the way to go tonight, you know what I'm saying? And anybody who know, we like to have our spirits in the building.
We just have what we're drinking today, right?
I know, but that's what I said, you know? So, yeah, champagne mimosas for today, because it's a celebration. So shout out to Lacey and shout out to Freshie, man, you know, we love y'all, you yes, feel me? And before I, you know what? I'm going to do that in a second. We got that little tribute. We're going to do that. But we got Wear Proper in the building. So, man, slide on up. You know what I'm saying? Get your mic going. Make sure you straighten it up in here. And, like, the first thing, of course, that we want you to do would be to introduce yourself and tell everybody, like, you know, where they can find you. Oh, yeah, you can scoot your chair in just a little bit more over here. And there we go. And yeah, you twist it just tap. There you go. Thank you. Bam. Okay. That is perfect. So, go ahead. Tell us, because your name is not Wear Papa. I keep calling you Wear Papa, but, you know, tell
it's
everybody.
Okay, look.
Tell
us who you
are, where you find on social media. What is this
brand? That was my name. So it's actually Wear Popa, but we'll take Papa.
Popa. Okay.
We'll take
Popa.
Papa.
All right. Popa.
So my name is Corey Washington. I am the CEO and founder of Wear Popa. And so Popa stands for Perseverance Over Privilege. And the A is, we have a little dash A, but it's the A means is we're based in design here in Atlanta, Georgia. And so what our brand was created to do was represent those who have reached their level of success through overcoming adversity to achieve that success and just really focusing the attention on them, our customers, as the hero of our story and just, you know, just celebrating them through our brand.
That's what's up. Yeah, I had that too. Wear Popa. My bad, because I've been telling everybody Wear Popa all day. So Wear Popa is a brand. Okay.
You guys, a little gift. Before we open it, tell us what inspires your brand.
You know what? It was a lot of personal, professional stories. So my background, actually, and in my full-time job is at an IT. So I'm a senior manager at a SaaS company or a software and service company. And I lead digital marketing as well as our professional services.
Oh, yeah, we went to
and so before then, I was in different agencies and whatnot, traveling around with clients. And I was always the quiet one in the room. I was the one that if I knew something, I just, for some strange reason, I did not have the confidence to really talk about it. And so, but I love collaborating. Yeah. And so every time my colleagues or whatever had a challenge or a problem, especially when it was something I was really close to or really knew about, I would go the extra mile of creating presentations for them, really sitting down with them, getting to understand them, their client, the problem, to create a solution for it. And I would give them all this documentation. They would take that and they would run with it. And they would call it their own. Because I was the quiet one in the room, I was the one that really wasn't one that people would bring in to the forefront of the client as much. I was kind of the back end person. And so I got discouraged about that. It really affected me in a way to where I did not think that, I started questioning myself, my own abilities and whatnot. And I said, you know what? Even through in the midst of everything I've been through growing up, and even in my professional life, it always got better.
Yeah.
It always got better. And I said, I'd much rather get to where I'm going in my life, in my career, especially through that of perseverance and that of privilege. I don't want it to be handed to me. I want to get there through the grit.
I want the privilege.
I want it both. You know what I'm saying? I don't think it's worth it if you don't work for it. So, I don't know. But yeah. Oh, okay. That's cool. We're going to open this together.
Ready?
All right, you ready? All right.
Oh, this is so cute.
It is. It's lit. Uh-oh. We got a little, got nails. I got that. I got you. We love gifts.
You're so beautiful. Are you from Atlanta?
I'm actually from Indianapolis, Indiana.
I love Indiana. Indiana. I love Indianapolis. I like Noblesville.
Okay.
It's quieter.
All right. Yeah, it is definitely quiet.
Okay, ready?
We're doing this together. You mean like together for real. Oh, we got a little letter.
If people buy your...
No, this is special.
It's special. Because we're special. But honestly, it's not too much different.
You gotta get a frame.
Oh, but it's not too much different. Oh, yeah, because we're going to put this right on in here. I'm going to get a frame. We're going to put this in here. Okay, so look, listen. On Blast Radio team, it's an honor to be on your show today. Thank you for allowing me to introduce Popa, share my story, and discuss the future of our brand. Enjoy this gift on us. Regards, Corey Washington, CEO and founder. Wonderful. Yes, this is your story. Wear it proudly. Okay. I could dig that. Uh-oh. Watch my drink. Yeah, so okay. So we don't forget because we got them drinks up there.
I love this sample.
Oh, my goodness. They're hoodies. We haven't received a hoodie yet. I'm glad.
It's getting chilly outside.
You know what I'm saying? So what
do
I say? See, that's a medium, so that's probably. I mean, that's small, and that's for you. Wonderful. So, hey, man, shout out to the fam.
Oh, thank you.
You know what I'm saying?
The level of effort that goes into, you know, we take special pride in just, we don't just take the items and just pack it into a bag and just sip it out. We actually literally steam everything.
Really?
Because, I mean, at the end of the day, we're always focused on our customers and what their story is, and we don't know what they've been through. And so we take special care in every single thing that we put out. There's people don't realize that everything's handmade. We steam it, put it in a package in a specific way. The envelope that they get that has their invoice on it or their ledger on it is black. It's really meant to give them experience because in a way it's us celebrating them, saying thank you. So there's a lot of special attention that goes into every single
thing. That's what's up.
I like this hoodie so much. I'm covering my boobs.
I'm sorry. She's covering her boobs. When it's hot here, I can't believe you put it on, but I appreciate
you're
you.
You're hot.
Well, I got on a sweatshirt already. Yeah. So, it's a little warm.
This is nice.
But it is
warm. I'd like to ask, whenever we
they said stand up for them so they can see it because, you know, our mics and everything was covering it up. So, yeah, give them a visual.
Oh, it's so lit. So
look
good,
at you.
Guys.
All right. Mid tag team.
Love that.
All right. Yeah, man. That's wonderful. I mean, I love the inspiration behind it. You know what I'm saying? That make me want to wear it.
It took me a while to get this thing out because of that. Because it was so close to me. It took me forever to get this thing out. About a year.
Sound like me.
Being a CEO now and having to be the person who is in the forefront, have you gotten over your fear?
That's still a work in progress.
Really?
A lot. It takes a lot.
You look really comfortable here.
That's good.
He said the champagne was
It's takes a lot to put yourself out there, because it's not one of those typical, it's not a typical clothing brand that is it is carefree, it is pretty light, but it definitely does has a meaning to it. And there's Absolutely. So many future plans we have for this brand in regards to making it a very strong storytelling brand.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because our customers are at the forefront.
I see you with like blazers and dress pants and all things like that. I tailored up. That's how I see it, man. I like even the name and like the whole everything behind it. That's what I see. Definitely. If I, y'all know, we can link. I got some shirts, you know. Like okay. We don't talk. You know what I'm saying?
If I'm listening to us right now on air or via video, and I wanted to buy your brand, where would I go?
We'll go to www.wearpopa, wearpopa.com.
Keep it easy. All right. Yep. On Instagram, wearpopa, okay? You so, got it.
Who's your favorite brand? Yourself.
There's so many. I'm gonna split up into two groups.
Okay.
Atlanta brands and mainstream.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna split you up into two groups as far as indie brands and mainstream brands.
Oh. Okay. All right. So my favorite high end brand will probably be Burberry. In Burberry with the CEO leadership of Angela Ernst.
Really.
It was so nice to see a woman from Indiana and New Palestine, Indiana, which is a country,
mm-hmm.
leading Burberry, an international brand, and bringing them into the forefront with complete digital evolution.
Yeah.
The way they create experiences for their customers is kind of where I've kind of gotten that. And as I see myself as a leader, especially as a future, a growing leader of this brand, is how I would treat my own employees.
Yeah.
I really admire her leadership. That's the more mainstream brand. There's so many, but the next one will be Atlanta-based brand, and that would be Wisdom Fashion House. Just like us, they are a strong storytelling brand. I don't know if they started off with this shirt, but one of their biggest sales that really got them out there was the shirt that says "In Rape Culture." It was based off a personal story from that CEO, That's one thing I feel like that's missing, is in order for us to be competitive, we have to connect with our people.
Absolutely.
We have to connect with our audience. And it's one thing, anybody can get a shirt and throw Pope on it, but really have an understanding of what that means and being able to have a relatability across the market.
Absolutely. That's how I feel about it. Like, you have to definitely be, passionate about what you're doing. Like, even with me, like the radio station. I wanted to do something that's going to help artists, like that's my most important thing. I don't care about, the money and all that other stuff, artists and small businesses, because I know they can't really afford it like everybody else or whatnot. So, you got to have a purpose. When you got a purpose,
definitely.
The mission is going to, everything's going to fall into place.
Definitely a purpose driven brand.
Absolutely. That's what's up, man.
So how long have you had this brand?
This is a funny story. I've had this brand for about a year.
Really?
Maybe a year and some change. I've had other endeavors that lasted, that spanned back to 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
They were a hot mess. it was me, it's trial and error, but honestly, failure and learning from failure builds the best leaders.
No, absolutely. Yeah.
That's how you really understand what you're doing, it's how you learn.
Yeah.
And so I started off with a brand called, and it's hard to say, it's called Citizen Inspire. I know,
and
that's why.
Yeah,
that got niched real quick. It was meant to say an everyday citizen and aspire as a symbol of strength, right? And I was getting stuff through AliExpress, but I was really hand-picking specific stuff because I didn't know any better. I wasn't the designer. I didn't think I could really go into more of the artistry of things and actually designing my own stuff. And then I said, I want to do my own thing because I really feel something with this. Mm-hmm. And I was starting off these brands actually initially to pay off student loans. I put myself through college. And so I was like, what can I do that I will enjoy, that has purpose and meaning? And I started off doing things like that. The next brand was called Mogul Collective. It was really about a group of entrepreneurs, a collective group of entrepreneurs who are learning from each other and sending out to build the next generation. but the funny thing is that, and that was, I was designing my own stuff, and I was not actually literally hand to the heat press making my own stuff, but these brands always had a collection, and that collection was Popa.
Okay.
And I really had to sit back as I sat back one day and I was like, okay, what do I really want to do with this brand? Because I feel like something's missing. Yeah. And I kept thinking about that little small little collection because it was always something I was feeling. And I said, you know what? That's it. I put it on a shirt one day and I walked out to the grocery store and someone said, what does that mean? And I said, oh, it's just perseverance over privilege. It's just something I wear whenever I'm feeling down, when I'm at work, or it helps keep me going and feeling inspired. And they said, you should really do something with that. And I was like, people are going to know, people are going to do something with the word POPA. I was like, what? And so, you know, I said, you know what, I'm going to do it. I talked to my family about it because they are a huge piece of my inspiration, my family and my partner. And we literally just, I just took it and ran with it.
Rolled it out.
That's good. Isn't it crazy how inspiration comes, but also how you decide what your brand is going to be?
Yeah.
Like, because you, the majority of the time, you're figuring out what to call yourself or your brand, and then it's crazy how it just, like,
yep, boom. It's right there. You need to know.
Damn, it's been there all along.
It's been there all year. Right. It's always there. It's 3 years. Just, right. But it was, I mean, just not wasted. It's a lot of lessons learned. Yeah. And honestly, I'm glad I went through those struggles, especially financial struggles with putting so much money into those things, because it helped me learn how to make things better and do things right this last time.
Don't you hate putting so much money into what you're doing just to get nothing in return? And you're just like, okay, I gotta be positive and think, I got knowledge. I might be homeless tomorrow.
Right. We'll figure it out. We know how to get
what I just do.
You gotta think about that $5 you spent last year.
That could have been one, I don't know.
I could have ate today.
Yeah, for real.
So where do you see this brand in 5 years?
You know what? The funny thing is I'm so extra. And because of the fact where I want to take this brand to so many different levels, especially where it's fusing technology and fashion together. Not only from a quality perspective of our brand, but from a design perspective, hiring designers to really come up with the next generation of our brand, but also from a digital perspective, taking a lot of those lessons learned from Angela Ernst, creating our own microsite that really is focused on the stories. We have the clothing, but we really want to highlight the people. Yeah. And almost to the point where we have this site that is broken down by industry. That way, if there's something that resonates to a young lady who is in a broken home and she really has this idea of being a doctor, and she wants to listen to the story of someone who also came from a similar situation and now they have a stethoscope around their neck.
Yeah.
Listen to a person who wants to, a young man who wants to be a barber or a project manager or an engineer. And hearing from other people who have come from somewhere.
That's how you know that you can do it.
Too. Yeah. So absolutely. We really want to be a storytelling brand that inspires and connects people of all backgrounds, but it also shows Black and Brown people that you can. We are designed for greatness.
Absolutely.
We are designed to be so strong. We've gone through so many things and
make something out of nothing.
Always
have. Absolutely.
And so there are so many different things that we have. So many different pieces of and cores of strength that we have within us that so many young people especially don't know they can do. It's so funny when I worked at my last company in technology and they said, hey, we're going to go to a school and talk to some kids about digital marketing and help them out with some campaigns, little mock campaigns they're working on. And I walked in, I said, sure, that's fine. That's when I was working at Salesforce Marketing Cloud. And I walked in there and most of the kids are Black and Brown. And they looked at me, my other colleagues are white, they looked at me like, what the hell?
Right.
Like, who?
Right. Yeah.
And I was kind of shocked at that point in time to see, like, they're, like, what are they looking at me for?
Right. Yeah.
But I got it.
You're their Black Panther.
So, and for them to see that, wow, we can do this?
Mm-hmm.
And in their mind, they're thinking you have to be an engineer. Mm-hmm. I'm a project manager. I am that. You don't want me building jack like that. Now, I can put together some cool stuff, but not like that. And so that is those are stories we want to make sure we tell as our brand. But mm-hmm. make sure our clothing is kind of like that constant reminder, that beacon that I am capable, and I can design my path.
That's awesome.
Bantu TV, one of our followers, Faris, she said that she think it would be wonderful with a new streaming service called Bantu. That product and brand is exactly what Bantu TV needs. So check it out. Go online and check out Bantu TV. Go online and check it out. That's what she said. That's right. Yeah. That's all handy dandy notepad right there. You know what I'm saying? And Bantu TV, check that out. And Faris, we appreciate you for coming in and checking us out and everything. But as she said, you know, she loved the brand and you know the story.
She don't ask
y'all to stand up so she can, you know, really see what was going on or whatnot. So there we go. She got you again. You got you again. You know what I'm saying? She got you again. Go on ahead again. All right. So another thing. So to me, I already know what makes you stand apart from everybody else. But to you, like, what makes you stand apart from any other brand or anything else that, you know, other people are doing? A lot of people are doing clothing and things like that now. It's really popular.
You know, the hilarious thing is we don't set out to be competitors, which is interesting for a CEO to say. We're not focused on others. A matter of fact, we were open to collaborating and congratulating others because that's just the essence of our brand. But what makes us stand out is really the story, how we approach the design and the future design of our product, how we approach quality. If you knew that process is also rigorous. It's just to incorporate one new long sleeve shirt is almost a weeks long process. And it's really how we approach, how we affect our customers, how we touch our customers. And so it's really about that storytelling essence of this that really makes us stand out.
This is what makes people connect. Absolutely.
So you talked about how you wanted to be able to reach your audience better. And you talked about the young lady who headed Burberry and how she was able to connect the brand with the digital world, and that's your goal. Mm-hmm. What are you guys doing right now to get to that goal?
Really, it's a lot of planning. We're taking things very slow because we want it to be right. We're not quick when it comes to new innovation because we want to make sure it works. There's ideas for using augmented reality with our shirts. There's ideas for taking stories of actual people and creating experiences for based off of that onto our different microsites that we're working on right now. We're trying to be as innovative as possible and be different, forward-thinking, and something that's unexpected. So we're just taking things real slow.
Man, I think that's lit. I think the brand is lit. I think the presentation is definitely lit, and the story behind it just makes it like even better. It just pulls everything together. So before we let you go and cut you out of here, I just want you to tell everybody where they can find you. Oh, Lacey got one more question.
I always finish it with, what is one piece of advice you would give an aspiring entrepreneur?
If it feels uncomfortable, you're probably doing it right.
I tell people that about modeling.
If it feels uncomfortable, you're right. Every stage of our growth, even though we're still in the infancy stages, mm-hmm. I mean, only like really being out there, I was technically, and it looks like a year, but less than a year. But every new step I took, it was incredibly uncomfortable, but I just did it because I knew it was the right thing to do. Don't be afraid of failure, which is probably a second thing. It's okay to fail. Fail
Absolutely.
Fast and learn,
and learn
from it.
From it. Absolutely.
And really just trust your instinct. Yeah. Trust your gut. Listen to people. Listen to your customers.
Yeah.
Get feedback. And that really will. And don't think you have to do it all yourself. So that's some
true
advice I would definitely
give. That one. For a very long time.
The ring.
Thinking, you know.
It took a long time.
But hey, man, you know, just like you, I've been at it for a year, and we lit, you know, with awards and magazines, it's just been on go. So I definitely, everything you said, like, I feel you with that. And yes, it has been uncomfortable, but we just figure out how we go. You know what I'm saying? Take it a day at a time. That's what I'm telling everybody, man. Just take it one day at a time.
Yeah.
It'll all fall into place.
It will fall into place.
Absolutely. So, again, tell everybody where we can find you at. You know, tell everybody where we can reach you. Any information that you want to give us about you, about your brand. This is your moment right now. It's your own personal infomercial to tell everybody what you got going on.
Yes, you can find us again on our website at www.wearpopa.com. Our Instagram is at wearpopa. You can also hit us up by email at wearpopa@gmail.com.
Wonderful. Hey, man, y'all better go head over there right now. Grab your hoodie, grab your t-shirt, man. You know, we got different colors and everything like that.
Oh,
we
far we're doing white and black. We did that by design for this first place. Everything we do is subliminal.
That's what I'm talking about.
Even the URL that says wear, but it's like we are.
Gotcha.
Everything we do.
Oh, yeah. Because we are. You know what I'm saying? Definitely. We're everything. Okay? If you didn't know, now you know. All right? So, Popa, if you want, I want you to, you know, stick around for a little bit. Because, you know, afterwards, we'll take some photos and we'll do, you know, everything like that. We just got another interview. But as long as you can stay and chill, man, we enjoy you being here. You know, we pull you back up and say some more. You know what I'm saying? All right? Okay. Oh, you need a refill before you go? I top you off.
By all means.
All right. That's what I'm talking about, little man.
We don't promote drinking on air, so we're going to cut.
All right. So we'll go ahead. I'll play a little song right here, okay?
Give me some. Can I get a shot?
A shot? Oh, yeah. Let me see, though. Corey, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be so much
later. Oh,
it's an Ashley song.
Huh?
It's an Ashley song.
I know, my girl. She's down there in the
Oh yeah, we love Ashley C, baby. Get my man Ace in here, please. Oh man, I done lost another song. What the heck is going on around here?
People got mad at me. I ain't the bottom and feel like we gravity. Bitches be blocking the police, harassing me. I get on stage and the bitches be grabbing. They traveling with accident. I be for accident. I can't get caught with that shit with the fantasy. I let the duck off my neck. She rapping and married. I ain't not feeling bad. I ain't got no money. She said she love me. I know she don't want for me. I don't want to be out for me. I don't want to be so good. I don't need that back. I'm going to be leader. My people don't got to me. I be in Jackson. I post up on travel. I know they pray. So I won't double vocally.
Bye, bye, bye.
Y'all keep that tucked in y'all background here. You know, we move seniors around here. Don't have my bitch on my hand. You know what's going on. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, I got you. We're going to take that thing outside. I got you. That's the show. You know what I'm saying?
Bro,
you
have
bear gifts too. Man, you said we bear gifts too.
Here you go, bro. I got
the remix of last year. I start now. Yo, so man, I'm excited because we got my bro, Ace Boone coming up in this place. I've been trying to get him in here since January, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, okay. So, for those who didn't know, Ace was supposed to be on my very, very first show. Okay. But, you know, technical difficulties and those things that go on. And I know Ace was preparing to come and hit me off with all this new music that he sent over to me. So, I can't wait to get into. Oh, yeah, the special guest that I was telling people about.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was
him.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, hey, yeah, we're going to see.
She waited for you. She waited for you. And you gave her some good D and told her you was going to come back. Like, she.
I'm slick. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, well, maybe you won't come. You know what I'm saying? It's busy. It's cool. You know what I'm saying?
She wasn't giving up on you.
No, but it's all good. He's here right now. You know what I'm saying? I know he was coming. I mean, it's my bro. He's always a call away. You know what I'm saying? So it's all good. So, Ace, man, first I want you to tell everybody, of course, who you are, where they can find you, and where they can find your music. That's the first thing.
Okay, well, I'm Ace Boone Coon. There we go. I'm live. What's up, good people? Ace Boone Coon, man. IG, I guess. IG.
That's right.
Ace Boone Coon, MP3. IG. That'll work. I'm in a well. Just Ace Boone Coon, you look it up, you just look for me, you know, because it's me.
Don't really believe the other folks, whoever else, you know.
The original is me, you know.
He hit you with the Google me. Hey, look. Ace Boone Coon. Find me on the ground, wherever else you can find me. You know what I'm saying? Because that's where I be at. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. All right, so you got some hot music coming up, you know what I'm saying? But first, you can tell everybody where would they not? Like, I know where I know you from, you know what I'm saying? But if y'all new to Atlanta or if y'all
y'all been living under a rock or whatever like that. You know what I'm saying? Why don't you tell everybody like your history with the city, with your music and everything like that? Because you've been making major moves for a long time. I mean, you took a little break, but, you know.
Yeah, definitely. We still got a lot of stuff going on, a lot of major moves going on. You know, I still got the production teams out of. Shout out to Rico, you know what I'm saying? All the production team, B Weezy, you know, Sunny Digital, everybody. We still got everybody moving, so we doing those things. So, you know, we went back, you know, kind of, you know, played the, you know, play the backfield a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Get my young guys in the way, you know what I'm saying? But y'all know me from, I had a hit single with Rick Ross, Young Dro, Fruity.
Yeah.
That was a big thing for me a couple years ago, you know. But you know, here we go, we review. You know,
that's where I do. You know what I'm saying? You spoke. That's where I knew. Like that song. Like I was in Detroit. Now listen to me. I was in Detroit and I knew about this song. So you know what I'm saying? Like, and when I came down here and okay, so I'm giving y'all a little story of how
me story time.
And, yeah, the story. We like story time. Right? Little story about how me and Ace met. You know what I'm saying? He knew. I want to say it was my sister or something like that. She's like, oh yeah, man. You know what? AC pulling up to the studio. We had a studio. We called it the Hip Hop Garage. You know, I have my I have my whole garage built out. You know, with the studio. Like I mean, our shit was legit. We had a booth and everything back in there, like the glass, the whole the door. Like I mean, like it was lit. Okay, so and he's like, yeah, my homie AC gonna pull up, whatever, like that. AC went there, and I'm like. Wait, no, like, no, that's AC, yeah, AC, I knew who he was, or whatever like that, so, I mean, since then, you know, when good energy come around good energy, it's just always a vibe, and, you know, ever since then, it's just like, oh, man, that's my bro, he's like, yeah, little sis, you know what I'm saying, and, like, we've been rocking forever, I mean, I'm talking about, at this point, it's been some years, or whatever, and so, I mean, you know, that's our story, and, I mean, never switched up. You know what I'm saying? Never, like, he just always been, I said, bro. You know what I'm saying? Oh, hey, man, that's bro right there, or whatever. So, I mean, I'm glad we got you down here, or whatnot. So, let's see. I have some other questions that I want to ask you, just about music in general, because, I mean, prior to me moving down here, my best friend told me, like, man, look, Atlanta, that's where you want to go. You want to do music, man. You need to be down there. You know what I'm saying? Whatever, whatever. Do you feel like Atlanta is a great place for artists to, like, get a start up as far as music and everything like that?
Yeah, I think Atlanta is a development city for artists. So I think an artist can come here and get developed, development, because we got all the studios, we got all the beats, we got, that's you know true. What I'm saying, we got all the stuff that
and all artists the freaking showcases, man. Right. It's a big ton of showcases out here, or whatever, for artists to really get out and cultivate their craft.
Mm-hmm. I haven't heard anybody say development, but that's so perfect.
Yeah, yeah. That's what it is.
It's perfect.
Development.
Absolutely, yeah. It's, I agree.
Because you can come here and develop, and then go somewhere and take over, you know what I'm saying, because here, you're going to get all your bases. You're going to get all the
startup.
Yeah, all the shit that you need to, you know, basically become a good artist. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Right. You can get that out here.
Yeah, I believe that. I agree with that. Because I developed a lot. I was able to do a lot of networking and just, you know, me and people. Even, it's a lot of DJs out here, too. And, I mean, if you're an artist, you definitely need to be linking with the DJs and getting your music to these folks and just building relationships, period. And that's something that I focused on when I came down here. And that, you know, pretty much got me to where I am. I started off wanting to be an artist, and now I've moved, like, just all around within, you know what I'm saying, like, the music, entertainment type of thing or whatnot. So, yeah, I definitely think it's a great development place as well. So I could agree with that.
Well, y'all gonna freestyle while y'all on air or no?
You know what I'm talking about? I'm so right on freestyle. Like, Jesus, man. Like, I did. Man. Where is it? Oh,
show. Show.
Let me know.
When my boy named Sway. Sway in the morning.
Right. Don't remember
me
to Sway. Ouch, my heart.
Lazy Sway. Lazy Sway. What's up now? Lazy Sway in the morning.
No, it's Lazy Sway in the evening.
Yeah, Lazy Sway in the evening.
That's right. Okay, I love that.
Lazy Sway in the afternoon.
We
might be able to get a freestyle or two out of, you know what I'm saying? A little something, you know what I'm saying? And I think, let's get into the interview, you know what I'm saying? A little bit more. I want to hear more of...
What inspires you?
Inspired. Life. Life in itself is inspiring itself, you know, just waking up every day and getting to see new stuff and new experiences. Life itself is my inspiration, you know, just living, seeing new stuff, doing new stuff itself. That's, you know, not necessarily other people or anything like that. It's just
getting life. And living your life and seeing new things and, you know.
New experiences. And
I could do that.
What inspires an artist, and I guess both of you guys can definitely answer this question, but what inspires an artist? One day you're just a regular, degular, schmegular person. And then the next day you're like, you know what? I think I can do this. And I'm going to just go hard for it. Like, what inspires that? And then what keeps you going?
The motivation, I think that just comes from the feeling of just knowing you can do it. You know, just believing in yourself. For anything, no matter, you know, your mind and your team, you gotta have the right people around you, you know what I'm saying, with the right people around you and the right motivation, you know, you can do it. And that's for anybody out there, everybody, you can do it. No matter, it don't have to be music, it could be
whatever you're doing,
you can do it. You just know that you can do it. You know, you could be in this 10th percentile that we in. We're all in this 10th percentile, you know. We're all in that, you know. You know, so you know, just believe in yourself. No matter what it is that you're doing, you know, that company that you believe you can't start it today.
Just go do it.
Yeah, you know, and tomorrow you may, you know, be in the millions. It start with the ones, you know, place value, you know. Yeah. Move on up.
I definitely agree. I think the belief in yourself is more important because the belief in yourself is what will make other people
believe. Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So exactly. To me, everything starts at home. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it starts right here, looking in the mirror at yourself, mm-hmm. or whatnot. And yeah, once you know that you can do it, and once you out and you know making moves, and I mean, you know, people, they gonna come. The ones who believe in you, the ones who mm-hmm. wanna ride your tail, the ones, everybody, they'll all come. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, that you don't have to worry about. And then you just have to weed out, you know, what's for you and what's not for you. And that's a process in itself too, because a lot of times the people around you can either help you or hold you back.
Exactly.
It could be a help or a hinder, mm-hmm. or whatnot. So you just have to, I definitely, you know, to me, what really kept me going, to me, this is something I want to do since I was a kid, you know what I'm saying? So, mm-hmm. and from there, it's just like, it always come back to the music. Even when I did other stuff, even when I feel like, oh, I gotta go get a job, I gotta go do this, so I gotta, you know, say, figure out a way, because if you don't have no money, you can't make it in music. I don't know. I mean, so look, if you thinking that you about to be a star and you ain't got no money to put behind yourself, just sit back down and rethink your whole plan. Figure out how you're gonna get that bag to get it happening, or get you a sponsor, or get you a whatever, however, you know what I'm saying, someone who believes in you, or whatever like that. But what really just kind of kept me going, it's just that it just always come back to the music. Like, I move seniors. I would have artists and, like, important people, like, just walk up on my door. Like, oh, my God, I move seniors. You know what I'm saying? So how I come across rappers and people in the industry and things like that or whatnot? You just know that this is what's meant for you. Take it from there.
I say that because I like you touched on that point, because I like the fact that you said that, because to me, I feel like if you do music, you liable to meet like a Michael Jackson. Or if you play tennis, you liable to meet a Serena Williams. Mm-hmm. Or if you play basketball, you liable to meet a LeBron James, because that's what you do. You feel what I'm saying? So anybody in that field, you're liable to touch bases with people in your field.
It just gravitates.
And once you begin to touch people in your field, and it's levels to this shit. It's levels now. So once you start, you know, getting growth in those levels, and you start meeting more people in that, you're like, oh man, I met this motherfucker, man. I never meet this person. That's how you know that's what you're supposed to be doing. That's how you know what you're supposed to be doing.
Absolutely.
How else can you know what I'm saying? It's just something. It's something that I think that in itself is like a sign. It's like, hey, I just ran into Lil Wayne today.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah. It's more than he died to meet Lil Wayne, but I met him today. You know what I'm saying?
That's real.
So that's how you know you're supposed to be doing.
Have you ever encountered, have you ever had a studio session that you wish you would, didn't pay for?
A studio session that I wish I didn't pay for? Nah.
Really?
Nah.
No bad session. Studio session that starts, nah. Really? You?
I was one of the people who, you know, I've gone to like a couple of professional studios and stuff like that, but I was one of the people who thought like offer it because like the people that I was dealing with, they would waste time and waste money in the studio.
Right.
So the first thing, man, I'm about to my own studio. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and I went out and I bought my own equipment and I did my own stuff. You know what I'm saying? And that kind of prepped me and that helped me to like I said, prep other artists and stuff. Like I said, when I met Ace, I had like 10-15 artists. You know what I'm saying? That was coming through to the studio or whatever like that. Yeah,
QC was over there in my garage.
I had all type of people over there and like I said, it just kind of helped me even be able to develop other artists and stuff like that. So, you know, man, like I said, once it's in you, it's just in you.
One piece of advice, though, you would give somebody young, because when you're young, you make all the dumb decisions.
Right.
So what advice would you give somebody young trying to come into the game?
Study.
Study what?
Everything. Study.
Your craft. It's books. I read books.
Study. Books on study music. Each, because there are components. You feel me? You know, you might, a lot of people think, oh, I'm talented. This is that. That's just the beginning.
For real.
You know what I mean? That'll help. You know what I'm saying? That'll help. If like she said, you need that money. So that'll help somebody give you some. Or that'll help you gain some, you know. But you still have to study.
And you gotta know the business. Because if you don't know the business, you're gonna get fucked. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, as talented as you are. As talented as you may be.
Y'all see the movies, the TLCs, the whoever else. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, you see it. So you have to know the business. And it's books. And it's like, the internet is full of everything, even before the internet. And I mean, and even like I said, like I was saying earlier, my man, if you upset because he got more notoriety or whatever like that, to go grab you a fucking Rhymer's Dictionary and a thesaurus, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? And get back down to the drawing board. You know what I'm saying? So to me, that's a part of studying. You know what I'm saying? You gotta know your craft.
I'm not a rapper. Right? No, this is real.
You gonna spit something for it, Lacey? Freestyle? You gonna freestyle?
No. But if you guys need me to write your ghost story, let me know. Okay, so look, because I'll write you a good story. But I'm not a rapper.
Okay.
And when you say get you a rhyming dictionary and like a thesaurus and you say study, do you be like, you know, sitting at your desk with your pen, your paper, with your like rhyming dictionary, your thesaurus, and like, what? Like, when you're in your zone.
What's
the process?
Now me, when I'm in my zone, because I'm the one who said a Rhymer's Dictionary, but I don't necessarily just have. Don't be like, oh, it's a Rhymer's Dictionary and it's a thesaurus right by me. I have those things handy just in case. The process is of course listening to the music. To me, I like to let the music speak to me. The music is gonna tell me the story that I'm supposed to write or whatever. And then from there, you know, I'll get started. But when you get started, sometimes you get stuck. When you get stuck, guess what? You got a Rhymer's Dictionary. What was the last word you said? Okay, so I could think of a word that I could put back there. And then now I got to put the sentence together that's going to go and make that word work. You know what I'm saying? Oh, guess what? A thesaurus. I don't want to use this word. I need another word because everybody used this word. So let me pick this word. You know what I'm saying? And bam, there you go. And that make your rhymes better and it make you different from everybody else.
You need to create a little rhyming game.
It's the truth session. We be dropping jewels. I started this radio station to help artists and small businesses. So that's what it's all about, man. But you know, and you can feed them all the knowledge you want to. That don't mean they're going to listen, they're going to do it. You can take the horse to the water, they're going to drink it. You know what I'm saying?
Leave it all to the water, nobody drinks.
Wait, so what's your process?
Me, personally, I like to get in my zone, you know, and most people know what that zone is. Most people already know. But listen, so when I get there, I just draw on the track. Like she said, I get into the music. It's more about the music. So when I hear the music, I know where I'm going to take it. You know, I just kind of get the story as I go along.
Hey,
I don't write nothing.
Really?
Everything that I do is
off the top of the dome.
Off the top of
the dome. Like old Lil Wayne. I'm not sure about new Lil Wayne.
same Lil Wayne. He don't change. He just gonna go in there and have some fun.
They said they hear that Atlanta accent in there, you know what I'm saying?
It's real. Oh, it's in now, man. This is okay. The dirty south, man. This is what we at, man, you know?
Do you ever just have experiences just to see what's going to happen, just so you can write about it later?
All the time. You know, you might be like, you know, because a lot of times lately it's been the trips, you know, because, you know, a lot of, you know, everybody know that I'm going again and moving again, so I'm invited over here, invited over there, invited over there, so... Sometimes I just go for the stories. Sometimes for the experience. Hey, man, I wasn't supposed to go there, but it's the day of cool. Let's go. You know.
Can you tell me one of your, like, just give me like a crazy story that happened, like something that you just was like, this really happened.
The craziest thing that happened. I was at the party when Meek Mill went to jail. That was crazy.
That was crazy.
So
they like just came in
there
like, you know what I'm saying, like just arrest
them? They didn't come in and just arrest them. I mean, it was actually a situation that led up to the arresting. Wow. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody partying, we having a good time. We was in L.A. So we in L.A., you know, they had an outside party, kind of like compound, like, you know, outside situation, day party situation. And DJ Drummer was DJing. He kept running the song back. He kept running back the hold up, wait a minute. That song right there. You know, the song started off mellow. But then it gets crazy. So what happened was they was playing the song. I was there with Tez, Lil Wayne, Nicki the manager. So we there. We in the cabana, right looking at the stage. They playing the song. And so as it mellow, you know, and it dropped, they go crazy. The Dream Chasers, the whole crew, they just going crazy. Every time the song drop, they just go crazy. So Tiz looked over at me. He was like, they don't know where they at. He's like, damn. He's like, that ain't no good idea. So I'm like, yeah, you know, well, you know, they, you know, meet them, pulled up, them brought out the cars out, they having a good night. You know what I'm saying? But like Ted said, we in L.A. This ain't no cheap party. You know what I'm saying? This one of them expensive parties. You know, motherfuckers in there wearing Versace. You know what I'm saying? So you ain't been to be spraying no liquor on no motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? That's what happened. They just kept spraying. Wow. As the song dropped, they just kept spraying liquor. Song dropped, they sprayed liquor. He started over again. It was DJ Drummer's fault. I saw that. You know you did that. You and Cannon. Cannon was hyping you up. I saw it. I witnessed that. Cannon was definitely hyping you up. But y'all did that to me. That was the craziest thing, I think. Probably. That was crazy. That shit was crazy.
All right, cool. So look, we gonna play one of your tracks real quick.
Which one we got? Which one we gonna do?
We gonna play Herringbone first.
I like that. Look at that. See, that how you know that my sister. That how you know.
But I want you to introduce it. You know what I'm saying? Let everybody know how much you love us over here on Blast Radio.
Okay. Oh, man. On Blast Radio, man. A Spoon Coon, Herringbone, featuring my little brother, Jay Stiggy. You know, and I love On Blast Radio. You know, this is the first time anybody that heard this song outside the studio.
You heard.
So, you know, take that with y'all. No pens, no papers, no none of that. Okay. Just straight.
All right.
Just straight studio.
My bro Ace, it is.
Want a lot of bread in the house, but we stacking out. Only catch us any clothes when we pack it out. $1 million nigga, knock him out, feel like Pacquiao. I been getting to the money since the end. A lot of young papers and they pullin' them a cush. Presidential rolling, they were rocking George Bush. Wait.
Then
the same old nigga still living by the code. We ain't changed those niggas. Be a friend, come a sword.
Shout out to our regulars, Stephanie, Angel,
Unimaginable, we don't do a go. You're super work, you're trapping, we're a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and I'm a little bit of a go. This is to the me, and
It's crazy how they treat a nigga like the Pope now. Wait, baby, yeah, that's the thong. Go around my neck, that's a hair bone. Still in the trap, you can hear the phone. If you really want the money, you can hear the song. Got a real bad bitch, yeah, that's the thong. Go around my neck, that's a hair bone. Still in the trap, you can hear the phone. If you really want the money, you can hear the song. Got a real bad bitch, yeah, that's the thong. Go around my neck, that's a hair bone. Still in the trap, you can hear the phone. If you really want the money, you can hear the song. Got a real bad bitch.
Take for you to say that I'm that nigga. And I be in and out of town like a travel agent. And how my money I be getting can't imagine it. And all these bitches pulling up and got them fascinated. Too many combo with a zero, can't exaggerate it. Wait a long way from that. Try to get a whole lot more before I go inside the ground. All the nigga know is that tomorrow ain't perfect. So a nigga gotta go out and get it right now. Step to the ceiling, get the motherfucking money. Nigga try to make a millionaire motherfucking week. Used to couldn't afford to put Versace on my back. And now I got Versace on my motherfucking sheets. Everybody gotta eat. Why you see the place? Probably got a bitch with his gates. Why you got a house with a lake? We don't make for nothing, tell them niggas be straight. Started at the bottom, now we motherfucking help. On the man of the motherfucking yo. Stack it up tall and put it on lip. What's funny, you can hunt, you can heal.
Got a real baby, yeah, that's the thong. Go around my neck, that's a hair bone. Still in the trap, you can hit the phone. If you really want the money, you can hit the song. Got a real baby, yeah, that's the thong. Go around my neck, that's a hair bone. Still in the trap, you can hit the phone. If you really want the money, you can hit the song. Got a real baby, yeah, that's the thong. Go around my neck, that's a hair bone. Still in the trap, you can hit the phone.
Now rocking All Blacks Radio Atlanta, home of the $5 spin and your number one station for independent artists.
And that's what they wanted. That's what they wanted. Let everybody know that. Yeah. And they bet y'all block my goddamn Facebook right here, goddamn. You know what I'm saying? That's how they try to do it. You know what I'm saying?
Swap you with blow. My niggas the goons. You niggas buffoons. I'm creeping.
Fruity. Young Joe, dead friend. Come. Look, real skin will be the thing. Hula. I can't recall the polo home. Threw it on the booty. Drop top,
dancing.
Purple weed,
dancing.
Smoke some wet weed, man. I got me home last. I will transform.
All right, I got you.
President Obama in the club on the wall. Like, tell me how you want. Fruity color ice, so I can freeze them in the sun. Green blush of being a home. Fruity color ice, so I can freeze them in the summer. Me and Ace on Mystery. Green blush of being a home.
Radio Atlanta, home with $5 spin and your number one station for independent artists.
You heard? Yeah. Hey, man. So, everybody wanted to hear that damn Fruity. And there it was.
On the comments.
But I want to say, because bro likes to, we got a whole lot of feedback going on right here. Okay, is that better? Turn that down a little bit. Okay, here we go. My bad, y'all. I know them ears is buzzing a little bit. But your track, Herringbone, that was my first time hearing it. Because, you know, bro waited today to sing me on this music. But that was my first time here. I really liked it. I don't know why I picked it first, but clearly it was the one
to go because
that's how you know. You know what I'm saying? Straight like that. But tell me, what was like your inspiration behind the song? Yeah, you know, like, I mean, I know you just went in there and did your thing, of course, but like, where did it come? Right, exactly.
Like I said, the music, it's more so the music. The music be kind of speaking to me, and then I use it as a canvas and I kind of paint on it. So that's how I do it.
This man is a painter. So, he's a word painter.
Yeah, that's really how I do it. I listen to a track, and it's the canvas, and I just kind of paint on it as, you know, what I feel. So that's why most of the songs gonna come out perfect to the beat.
100. We played back-to-back one of your new songs, one of your older songs, and you mentioned earlier that you took a hiatus.
Mm-hmm.
What would you say is like the difference between your music now and your music back then before your hiatus? Is it different? Is it the same for your fans?
Definitely a difference. Early on in my career, you know, I wasn't as focused. You know, I wasn't even ready for everything that came as fast as it came. You know what I'm saying? Everything just started happening real fast. And when you're not ready for that, you know, you just kind of go with what you know. You know, you just kind of go on with it. And so that's what I did. I kind of picked up and ran with it. And over the years, you know, I've done a lot of studio work. So I've done a lot of, you know, writing for other people and those things. So I think the developmental part is the big difference. I've developed into something else.
Right.
Yeah, it's a lot of growth.
I definitely get that's what's up, man, because of course growth is where it's at. Let me see. Katie had a question. She said where will you be at next? Are you like doing shows or are you like, you know,
making appearances
at places or
something? Yeah, we just popping up right now. I wouldn't say no shows you know, per se, because we haven't, you know, have nothing arranged at the moment.
Right, because right now we got to do exclusives, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Ain't nobody even heard yet.
Right now we in the background still, you know, getting our marketing together, everything, getting ready to exercise out here in these streets and do it the way we do it. That's what's going on right now. Not no shows.
Okay.
No, like there's no events. Well, you know, well, maybe we'll be able to pull him out to this Halloween birthday thing, and maybe you guys will see him there. Who knows? You know? You have other ventures outside of music. Like, I've seen you, what are you building? You're building something, he's grabbing up land and doing construction and things like that.
You know, if y'all got any land for cheap, call me. We buying and building, man. Everything is brand new. I do ground up construction. Everything brand new. We ain't got no investors, none of that. You know, it's all out the pockets. That's why y'all can see me here again. See, I just wanted to be in creative control. That's all. That's all I ever asked for.
So you have a construction building.
Business.
So a lot of construction businesses, even in Atlanta, are owned by not melanated people.
Aha, we know.
So how did you get into construction? What made you want to go into that? Wow.
Money. The money.
The best motivation. There the money.
Just understanding that, well, like I said, it's levels. So, you know, in the streets, you like, we just trying to get a couple thousand. You know, you're trying to graduate from a couple hundred to a couple thousand. And once you get to a couple thousand, you're trying to make a couple 10,000. Once you get to a couple 10,000, then you're trying to make a couple 100,000. In your mind, you have to say, how can I do that?
Yeah.
So that's the thing. And once you, you know, come across a couple ideas and you realize, oh, I can flip 100. I can flip 100,000 and make 200,000 off of this flip. What's the better way to do that than to go buy you some land and put something on it?
Absolutely. I mean, they say you gotta own something. You
gotta own something.
You gotta own something. So that's what's up.
In the route of like real estate. So you put in the right of I'm in awe because a lot of people, especially us, will go the route of real estate.
Right.
And we just think, oh, we just buy buildings or buy. Then we could rent, and then we'll make that money. But you've gone into
the money slow. That money's still going to be slow. And you can rent it 1,000 times, the money's still going to be slow.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing going to be like building it from the ground or putting your money into it, selling it, and watching yourself make 100% of the profit.
Right.
Watching yourself do it.
So you're going to sell the buildings that you
Oh, yeah. As soon as I build it up, there's already going to be somebody always ready to buy because it's brand new. It's brand new from the ground up, and we're building what they want. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And especially for the money that we're charging for. You'll be surprised because you're going to go buy your old house for $300,000. You can come see me and get you a brand new one for that same ticket.
Yeah.
So, it's that.
Make a whole lot of sense. Me. Okay, so, you know, not just music moves, but business moves. That's what we're talking about. You know what I'm saying? You got to definitely expand and you know, diversify. You know what I'm saying?
The
portfolio
got to
be. I mean,
you know what I'm saying? What they say was, is it 8 strings? You know what I'm saying? 6, 8, 10? I mean,
you
whatever.
Definitely,
you know what I'm saying?
More than one.
For real.
You definitely need more than, if you're going to do it yourself. That's just saying.
100.
You know what I'm saying?
Uh-oh, so they said, man, they used to surf to that goddamn Fruity on the south side. You know what I'm saying? They said that was they shit back then, bro. But I also got another question from one of our viewers that says, what advice would you give to an upcoming artist that's like an aggressive woman that's trying to go mainstream? So, you know, they got like a lot of the only hardcore woman that's really come out is like Young Ma and the other one out of Detroit, but she went to Philly, and we didn't already forgot her name. So I mean, she's from Detroit, and I'm from Detroit. So let a nigga try me.
There you go.
And she was kind of hard when she came out, but then she softened up a whole lot. So, but
I think with that, even with Young MA, if you take you take Ooh and you listen to it. And you don't really hear the aggression. You just hear the smoothness of. That's why you're gonna listen to that record. You're gonna play that record. You're gonna play it over and over again. Even the first time you hear it, you're gonna play it again. And the reason why is because it's mellow and it's just cool. It's just that record. Like you like. You ain't even think that that was a girl on there. You ain't really even know. You was not even sure. But it's a vibe, though.
Well,
you
know? That's what. I'm glad you said that. Only because the person who asked was, I mean, I know she was asking for mellow, cool as fuck. And I mean, clearly, you know what I'm saying? Clearly, her music is mellow and cool as fuck. So there it is, man. Make sure that your music got a nice vibe or whatever. Like,
you don't want to scare the shit out of
you. Don't think about the look. It's pretty much what he's saying. It's all about the sound. It's about the music. Focus on the music.
Real quick, I'm a feminist. What you said was, don't scare the fuck out of us when you come on.
Thanks.
Why can a man scare the fuck out of me when he comes on? And I listen to him and I still bond to him.
Him neither.
X extension.
Well, no,
Pop Smoke. Okay. Pop Smoke sound was.
But watch this though. Okay, now. Do you guys just see what route she just went to even try to cover her ass? She said. She named two people that's no longer even here. Guess what?
That means
a lot, because guess what? Them people didn't even have the recognition that they got until they left. Am I right or am I wrong?
Pop Smoke had recognition.
No, he didn't.
I did not know who he was.
No, he didn't. No, he didn't.
I did not know who he was.
You didn't know who X Extension was before he died?
They had
a little light.
Yeah.
But they didn't have what they have now.
So did Nipsey Hussle, and he wasn't, you know,
I didn't find out who he was till right before he passed, but
with Nipsey though, Nipsey had things he had an impact different from just the music. It wasn't even the
but
music.
We didn't know him until he died either.
I knew him from the marathon.
A lot of people knew him.
From his impact, but not from his music.
What I'm saying, from his music, he still had early on tracks with people like Drake. And those things. So that's what.
Pop Smoke had music with Nicki.
But listen to what I'm saying. Exactly. See what I'm saying?
Never.
See what I'm saying?
That's you personally, but he had a large family.
I mean, so, and I'm one of many, and I listen to music, and I'm on a radio station. Never heard it.
Yeah, but there's a bunch of music you've never heard. There's even music you don't play.
And
so
we're not saying that. Because, and like you said, it's a lot of music that's out doing its thing, people getting paid for it, and we've never heard it.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is, as far as the world is concerned, we're talking about superstars.
Bone Crusher had really, really aggressive music, and we used to listen to him.
That was a different time.
It was because Lil Jon was aggressive.
And they've been men who have been able to make it with aggressive music, but to say to a woman, don't scare us on the track. And we'll listen to you. You gotta have mellow music for us to listen to you. It's like, wait.
For a woman to do it raw, I don't believe.
Well, I mean, but even still, younger man, she was still raw, but it was a smooth rawness. It was a smooth rawness.
That's
what he's saying. He's not talking about necessarily the lyrics. He's talking about the sound.
If
the
it was
beat,
a girl who sounded like Busta Rhymes, but she coming like Busta Rhymes, we not gonna be against it. We gonna accept it because. Long as you know how to style. Just style with it.
So
whatever
style,
it is.
Don't not scare us, but style it.
Oh, I'm sorry, I finished the feminist. Oh, God. I offended. She's speaking for all the women in America when she says.
We better have representation.
We're going to roll into this problem or something. You know what I'm saying? It's really cool. Problem or something. You know what I'm saying?
I appreciate that. Style it.
Rocky
style it.
Rocky man.
Right. That's good, ladies.
I got that cape with a pull. Say they gon' give me that show.
She give everybody a hard time. Don't feel special.
So one thing about me, you know, I can have a conversation. I ain't true. All day.
Cause she wanna know where I'm from. Talk about money, but my kind of law. Wanna know what I'm smoking, don't smoke a V-long. Wait, I put that gas in that leaf. I fuck with choppers, you niggas, I had this. You niggas be fucking with thieves. Call it and call no keys.
Pull out that sound of my nuddle. Say you a gangster, bitch, shit up. Hop in the truck and I cuddle. She like to fuck with a puddle. Niggas be coming and guessing, but they don't be guessing what next we pull up. I got this scope, jump on that boat, burn on the go, bitch on the go. Out with this shit, nigga, we broke. Ain't got no time to fuck with me, folks. I had the kids in the way, nigga. Fuck with the kids, I'm taking
the soap. On Black Radio, this is first play, this is first play, they get all of you. Right now. Everybody heard it. I had to bring it to my sister. She don't want to hear it first. She already knew it. So it's going to go.
Certified down to the lab. My niggas shit even bread. I get more fat than a cat. My head don't like to be and we get the money in rails. Stay eating lobster and grails. Still I can't fuck with your crowds.
Never did my sins and nails.
Paperwork check out the side. I want the money to
die. Well, you know me, man. We love this. So my sisters, they definitely going to rotation.
How many niggas acknowledge?
Wait.
The fact that you niggas ain't real. The fact that you niggas post all in the game and still haven't got you a meal. The fact that your partner still locked them chains and still haven't got no appeal. You been even selling your nigga no money. He don't even know how to feel.
Wait, bro. Hey,
Down, old bitch on that old shit. She done hot, I know some old dick. From a symbol to a whole brick, whole life and did a whole flip. Wait, I ran that money up, and only bitch really mad about it. Only money really sad about it. All my pockets really glad about it. Falling in trouble, I'm in it. I got that money, I spend it. Smoking on my money, I got a thing for these women with me. She think I'm
broke. That's alright, we got them. I got some beats from our big battle competition, so Faces by AC Boom Coon. So of course you know you can find that right here on Live 365 / On Blast Radio Atlanta. We got all the exclusives that Nasty Ho have not dropped yet. Exclusive. Blueface have not dropped yet. Exclusive. Problem or Something have not dropped yet. Exclusive. And that damn Herringbone, I really like that one, but I love that Blueface too. Have not dropped yet. Exclusive. You're only gonna find it on Blast Radio Atlanta. So you need to go ahead and make sure you go to onblastradioatlanta.com. And click on tune in. That's all you gotta do, man. They all right there for you. You feel me? But
Mello, you there? You live? Oh no, wait, let me turn you up a little bit. I can hear you, fam. You got a question for Ace. What's your question?
Yeah, so Ace, how you doing? First of all, I'm Mello Cool Sports. Appreciate you for that, yeah, nah, Bob. I'm also fucking with the new music too. Just want to say thank you for being a pioneer in this game. But my question is, how did you feel any type of pressure to change as the music started to evolve, like the music industry?
No, most of my pressure came from my peers. That was the that's why I took the hiatus, because you know I was tied in with a lot of people, so the things were. You know, talking to other people and those things, so you don't know. So in that transition, you trying to follow your heart, but other people, you know, want you to do other things. So that was the biggest pressure point. But you know, I took the hiatus so I could understand that I was on the right path.
Now that's so very true.
Okay, that's real. So I have one more question, and I'm gonna hop up off the line and let y'all finish with this bomb ass interview. My next question for you. It's like, what would you do right now for any artist like me that's out here that's really trying to break in the game? Like, what type of advice would you give me to follow on me being a female, me being a lesbian rapper, and me being a stud rapper, which means, you know, I'm a little bit masculine. I'm still kind of feminine, but I'm a little bit masculine, too. Like, what advice would you give me to, as far as, like, how I should come in the game or maybe some pointers or something that you could tell me, like, tell me something.
I tell you, give them hell, you feel me? Just take your time. Make sure you're doing the right records. You know what I'm saying? The main focus is going to be your music. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. If you get the right music and just do the marketing. It ain't nothing, you know what I'm saying? Don't be afraid. Don't let those little stigmatisms, you know what I'm saying, throw you off your course. You know what I'm saying? Just stay focused. You know what I'm saying? Don't, you know, as long as your music good, they're not worried about what you look like. Now worry about, you know what I'm saying? They just ready for you. They just want to see you at that point. So that's the main thing. You know what I mean? Just stay focused. All
right.
Just give it to them. You know what I'm saying? Don't.
Okay.
Don't let up on the ass.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Don't focus on it too much.
Don't scare them.
Yes,
don't do that. Don't do that. All right. So.
Hey, Lacey. Oh, yeah. Lacey, I want to say congratulations.
Thank you.
Glad to see you back on the show.
Thank
glad
you.
To see you all perky and, you know, doing your Lacey doll things, you know what I'm saying? But, oh, yeah, and look, I'm having a party on October 30th, April.
Ace already going to be there, man, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Shout out to you.
It's already going down. It's already playing.
Well, listen, when we play that song, I need you to get up and turn that
bitch
up. You know what I'm saying?
One thing about it, I ain't scared.
That it.
I appreciate y'all. Hey, man, y'all doing good, man. I'm loving the show tonight. I'm tuned in. I got all my folks watching too, man. Listen.
That's what's up.
Hey, Boom Boom, thank you again for dropping them jewels, man. I'm out of here.
Anytime.
Hi, Mello.
Already. Man, that's what I'm talking about. All right, so. Of course, Ace and get love from all over and all around because, man, like, y'all heard it. This man don't use a pen, okay? Nah, this blue face is, I mean, don't get me wrong, like, I was impressed. I'm always impressed. Like, bro, he fine, period. You know what I'm saying? But the blue faces really, really, like, kind of stood out to me. And I'm just like, this nigga didn't have no pen. I'm sitting over here, I'm like, this man didn't have no pen. You know what I'm saying? And, man, I love it. I've always loved everything that, you know, that you do or whatever. You know, you always have my support or whatnot. How about you tell everybody what you feel is, like, really next for you?
I feel like I'm going to that place, you know what I mean? It's just a feeling I can't even explain, you know what I'm saying? Like, everything going right in the universe, I just feel it, you know what I'm saying? I just know the feeling, you know what I'm saying? Being that it ain't the first time, show ain't the last. So it's just a feeling. I'm going to that next level, you know what I mean? Just
letting them
know.
Okay, so man, I love this chain. It's a BCS. What's that?
It's a Barcode Society.
Barcode Society.
Shout out to T. Gutter. Barcode Society, man, Mr. Snowman over there.
There it is.
When Mello was on the line, you talked about how most of the pressure that you got
didn't come from the industry, but it came from your peers.
Right.
And that's why you need to take your hiatus. When you say pressure, was it pressure to stay the same or pressure to change?
Pressure to change.
Really?
It was, pressure to change with the time. It was a transition. I came, I dropped Fruity before the internet was a thing, was the a major thing. Let's just say a major thing. MySpace was the major thing when I dropped the record. So the transition was, you know, Soulja Boy. Soulja Boy was like the first transitioner. And when he came
the
in,
the ringtones and the little things, the internet really, like, it was like vital to what we were doing. Yeah,
so they didn't know, nobody know which way to go. You know what I'm saying? It was like a big huddle for all the labels. Everybody was not knowing what to do because the internet began to take its course. You know what I'm saying? So the pressure came from that. It was mostly that. It was the people, who you think you should do? Try this and sound like this and do that. That was the pressure. So it was kind of like, I don't even want to go to the studio.
Right, you don't even want to do that. Because it's heavy on you. You know what I'm saying? Like, the things that people project on you, the energy and the things that people project on you, it really can. You definitely, at times, you just need to fall back and really figure out where you at and where you want to go and do your thing, you know what I'm saying, instead of feeling all that outside, whatever. You said mouthful there. So that's been recent.
Did you do a lot of your promoting on MySpace back then?
Yeah.
So, okay, this is great. Okay, I want to make sure we're fast enough. Sorry. Because MySpace was the first... MySpace was the first time that artists and entrepreneurs got to promote themselves on social media. Right. Without a MySpace, there would not be an Instagram.
That's how I started. Okay. So, MySpace was lit.
For you, right? I felt like a whole developer. But I was a whole poet in my little thing. But for you, right?
Yeah.
Being on that wave, not because a lot of people missed that wave and now they're jumping on the Instagram and the TikTok wave, but for you to be on that wave.
Right.
What would you say was the most interesting thing about coming into the industry at that time?
I think the success rate was like, because that's what was going on. You know what I'm saying? It's like the internet was kind of like where you could see your success right in your face. You know what I'm saying? It was kind of like, true. You ain't have to look for the numbers or none of that. All you had to do was click on MySpace and say, damn, this song just did a million.
Right.
Shit. Like, overnight.
Yeah.
I think it was that.
It was definitely
that.
Because that's definitely what happened to Soulja Boy. That's
right.
Yeah. It was
right.
Just like, boom.
He changed the entire... Like, when Soulja Boy... People always come at Soulja Boy because of how he is now. But when Soulja Boy makes comments like, I am the industry. I changed the game.
He did.
If not for me, y'all wouldn't exist. Ray Shrimmer who, right? And people come at him and they always attack him for making these comments, but...
He hasn't made a false one yet.
No one knew what to do. Right now.
No one knew what to do.
Look, shout out to my boy Big Draco. You know what I'm saying? Because it was you. You and Charlie. Shout out to Charlie.
He didn't know what to do. So, okay. So, like, what advice would you give somebody? Because even though, you know, Instagram and TikTok, they're a little bit different. They're a lot different than... Right. MySpace, which was life. I didn't even know why Facebook became a thing.
I mean, I'm saying.
I don't know why. How?
MySpace fell off and Facebook became a thing, but MySpace was so
It was
lit.
Everything in one.
Yeah, it was
dating, entertainment, networking.
Yeah. Oh, man, your top fans.
LinkedIn.
Like, that top fan thing was like a big deal on fucking MySpace, bro. Your top couple people.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like, when you put them up on the
You might have to fight about that shit tomorrow.
Facebook, y'all need the top fans. You know what I'm saying?
Right. World Star used to post who celebrities posted as their top eight. Like, it was a real thing.
Yeah.
But even though they're slightly different, social media fame is social media fame, and social media networking is social media networking. What advice would you give somebody who's using social media as their main source of networking now?
Oh, that's the best thing to do to me, because you reach a lot of people faster. You know what I'm saying? Motherfucker gonna pick up their cell phone before they turn on the TV.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
Yeah.
So you just gotta know that now. You know what I'm saying? And it's true. That's why it's a big thing, because it's fast, it's rapid. You know what I'm saying? The stuff that we see on the news, we know about that shit before the news actually start talking about it.
That's true.
We already talking about it. It's right. Like, so that's how you know. You know what I'm saying? It's the small details that people don't pay attention to. But the cell phone is the key. So social media, do all your marketing there.
What's crazy is, you know, you guys, I like to drop these little things for you guys. I was a broadcast media major in college. And one of the things that they told us was, one of the ways that it changed the broadcast industry was social media, right? As your first form of media. And then after that, news, magazines, and then newspapers, right? You don't even learn about newspapers anymore.
Hardly ever. That's the last thing. Right. You got a printer. You know what I'm saying?
He got this knowledge from life. So when earlier in the interview, he said life is his inspiration, it's his motivation, it's his teacher. Literally, if you pay attention to what's happening around you and if you allow yourself to live life, he said earlier, it's okay to make mistakes. Literally, if you live your life that way, you're going to gain what some people pay $30,000 for in a classroom. You guys, let life literally guide you. Do not miss those opportunities. One of the things that you said, and I loved, because I'm a writer, is you have experiences sometimes just like for the storyline. Like, what's going to happen from having this experience? I'm going to just say yes and show up and see what's going to happen.
Exactly.
Right? Mm-hmm. I love that. Live your life that way, because some people literally do pay good money for the knowledge that this man has. But I'm not saying you don't have a great education, but he has this knowledge because he's done it. He's lived it. He's experienced it. He's allowed himself to literally absorb that knowledge. And I love it.
100. I love it too.
I love it.
Guess what? I haven't played a commercial in the longest time.
Really?
We don't pay these bills. And goddamn, you already know what. That was before AC even got here. So here go a nice commercial for you guys. We're going to come back with some music. We're going to come back with the last couple words from Ace, because we rolling on in at 10 o'clock, man. Now I feel like the time just flew around here. We had some really great interviews tonight, and man, you know, time always flies when you're having fun. So here we go. We got this ad break for y'all. Man, let's pay some bills.
Dear John,
uncontrollable
blood pressure is serious, and I can quit
you
whenever I want.
Who your favorite rapper
star? Why can't we get back to when you check
in? I'm going to ask you that, okay?
I don't want to leave.
Top five.
Remember,
when I quit,
you quit.
Yeah. We're talking about period, or we talking period. About...
Yay! We need another one, Dad.
This is WWE superstar Alberto.
Don't tell me.
It only takes a moment to make a man.
I can't wait to know.
Take time to be a dad today.
Visit fatherhood.gov, brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
It may be hard to believe, but people just like you are already saving money. FeedThePig.org makes it easy. Their simple savings plan teaches you how to start saving without going overboard. So you don't need to sell all your belongings and live in a commune. These dungarees belong to all of us now, Tom. You don't need to get a second job in a stuntman. You just need FeedThePig.org. Don't get left behind. Get tips and tools at FeedThePig.org. Brought to you by the American Institute of CPAs and Ad Council.
And me. Yes, and Lisa, a lot. She always has. I do, I have to pee, so. Because she always has to go. Oh, commercial break. I'll be right back. Y'all talk amongst yourselves.
That's right.
Keep it rolling.
you up to hate and shit, but that's how some of these niggas be, and I ain't no rare shit,
baby. I appreciate Kanye, because you know what?
I'm dropping new shit every month. Niggas can play if they want. They know I got sticks in the front. Bitch, my name's solid as fuck. The plug gave me front from the jump. They smoking on stuff. My niggas move back like a truck. Fucked out a truck. I just want money and love. Rushing diamonds on my niggas and trust. I ain't never listened to such a shit. That's just mad cause ain't nothing to help. When I took the car, hit them all in the dust. Run me the front, say lost my trust. I ain't tell you this is real, but I kinda ain't want me down. So don't look me up. Shut. Man, hell, the box is a cuss. I know these niggas say my best. But I don't get no flake, bitch. You do it, oh, I love. Yup, I'm on some new shit. She ain't no new shit. Straight on the new shit. Ooh, she's sick of Jewish. Take the beat and abuse it.
I'm on some new shit, girl. I'm on some new shit, bro. And I ride my way, my ego is big and I look like a cruiser. So my flow will be foolish, and my vision the truest, yeah. Cause I'm back in the deep, yeah. Man, your nigga look like this.
I'm on some real shit. I'm on my wife and my baby, man. I'm on some real shit. I'm on myself and I'm taking hits. My tall hoe, she is thang. If I take her home, she is thang. I be fucking up too big things.
Yo, man, shout out to my brother. My brother Dre Bills and his crew. Man, that's my brother right there rapping. Y'all make sure y'all follow my brother Dre Bills on Instagram. You know what I'm saying? DREBI2L. What is it? It's in, okay? Dre Bills.
Put your back in the D. Man, your nigga, do this.
I'm my team when I'm shooting.
Oh yeah, and when I say brother, I got a lot of brothers, but it's like my blood brother, like my father's son, like, okay, you know what I'm saying? So I have a music family, okay?
I'm on some new shit, bruh. And I ride my way, my ego is big, and I
look like a cruiser. Cause my floor be foolish. Hey. Cause I'm back in the deep. Yeah. Now your nigga a doofus.
So look, man, I'm dedicating this one right here to Lacey Dell and Freshie. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
She wiped it. You know what I'm saying? So congratulations to them. Man, y'all make sure y'all follow Freshie, man, and go download the track. You heard me?
You like the way we rollin', how we rollin'. You like the way we movin', not controlling.
That's how we do that, mama.
You like the way we're driving, we're in motion. You like the way I live if you ain't noticed. Cause I'm the type of nigga that you ride for. You don't want for nothing. Get you what you need, not asking for it. I'm a real G, no frontin'. Get you all excited. Never been a side. Give you what you like because I like it. Everything that you want.
You ready? We ready?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Okay. So please tell me who is in your top five? Who you listen to today?
Top five first, then we'll listen.
Okay.
Okay. Top five all time. I'm going to start out with Tupac. Just because. It is what it is. We're going to go Tupac. Then I'm going to say like Tupac, like Jay-Z, I like Eminem.
Really?
That, that's a new one. You know, no one has ever said.
Man,
shout out to Detroit. Okay, so look, he ain't from Detroit, but shout out to the homie because he rep Detroit. You know what I'm saying? He's from the other side of the tracks, but you know, whatever. Okay, go ahead.
Definitely gonna pull Eminem into that, no matter what they feel. He's definitely
scary, but women can't be.
Oh man,
it's some crazy women that's doing their thing.
It is
definitely.
They're
out here. They're not Eminem
status.
Who's your fourth? Third.
Second.
The
what?
Third.
He said three people.
Yeah.
Who's that?
Oh,
you
calling
one
up.
Okay.
I got you.
I was coming down.
I'm going to go with
Drake.
Really? I love that. That's good.
I'm definitely
going to
go with Drake. Then after Drake, I'm
going to
go with Common.
Oh,
I love Common.
No one else is coming.
I like the same vibe.
Yeah,
me too.
Okay.
I like that.
Who you listen to today? Because there's
who's anybody, mainstream, indie, like whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like what's well, you know what? I want to know. You can tell me who you listen to, but I want to know really who you think that is out here right now, indie, because we support indie artists. Like your favorite indie artist that you feel like is really doing his thing. Like next
or
up.
Her.
His or her,
yeah.
I'll be right.
Big
thing, my bad.
Big
thing.
Yeah, it's so many.
Go ahead,
name you already know, so that I'm a big supporter of everybody who's doing it independent, just because you know I knew what that role was.
Yeah.
So I do a lot of stuff, shit for free. I've done a lot of shit, a lot of charity work. there's a lot of motherfucking indie artists that I know that are doing their things, like a lot of them. And I can't even begin to count or name because it's so many, and I don't want to, you know, leave anybody out or make nobody feel no type of way.
No, man, fuck that. Don't feel offended.
No, but it's not even that. It's just that it's so many. You know what I mean? It's so many. Like, for real. Shout out to my boy Omari right now. Omari Cardion. He's definitely doing his motherfucking thing with that. Don't play with him. Don't play with him. He ain't playing. You know what I'm saying?
Omari Cardion. Like, send that on over to Omari Cardion. Don't play with him.
Omari Cardion. And I'm definitely going to make sure Sus got that record. Don't play with him. I ain't gonna even tell him about the surprise that's coming with that record tomorrow, but that's for you just because you're on my mind right now.
Okay.
My nigga, shout out to you. You know what I'm saying? We know what you about to do. We got our own artist. Shout out to Kobe. Kobe about to do his motherfucking thing. We got a big situation going on with him right now. It's so many because, you know, I work background as well, so I got so many people that's in.
The production,
and we put in
the
good seats.
So you got some of the motherfuckers that
we got in the takeoff out here. So, you know, shout out to that. You know what I'm saying?
Well, so who are you listening to?
Who I'm listening to mostly, I'm listening to Drake a lot. You know, I listen to Drake a lot because he just, the motherfucker that's
And he's relevant. He's very relevant and he does. You know, one thing that I love about Drake that I've noticed more so lately when I be really like listening to his lyrics versus other artists.
Right.
Drake, one of these songs that he got, he talk about how he wanna live for a long time and he wanna slow death. You know what I'm saying? Like a lot of these artists they talk about like, oh, they gonna die and people about to kill them and you know, but don't understand that you speak life into yourself and you can speak things into existence. So the people who are speaking on things like that are like, these people want to be dead and they want this and whatever, and they speak about the bitches and the hoes and I got this and all that other stuff, and they don't think positivity into the things that's around them, and then they have these situations and things that happen to them or whatever. When I be listening to Drake lyrics, he be talking about like, man, I want a bad bitch with a bag and whatever like that. I want a slow death and whatever, and I'm out here and I'm doing it. He speaks life into his music. Nothing, like hardly ever negative type of innuendos about himself and about his crew and about what he's doing. And to me, I just think that amplifies his movement and his music and his message so much further because he is manifesting all those great things into his life as he's entertaining all of you. You know what I'm saying? And as he's doing his thing or whatever like that, he's also bringing all the things that he want to happen in his life to him.
To fruition.
Absolutely.
Are you listening to any female rappers right now?
Female rappers right now?
Mulatto.
Yeah, most definitely. Shout out to Mulatto. Definitely. Definitely got the... Got, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Mulatto. I've watched Mulatto come a long way. So shout out to Mulatto in the South Side. You know what's going on.
Man, we love Mulatto. You know what I'm saying? All the homies, all the homies, we all love Mulatto.
Love
and
Mulatto.
Then, you know what? I really like Megan Thee Stallion. Like, okay. I like her lyrics. I like her,
her aggression.
Like, even, bruh. And, it's different for me because, you know, like, so I'm a stud. I'm kind of, you know, masculine, female, whatever. People have all these fucking ideals of how you're supposed to be and all this other stuff. But, man, I promise you, I be fucking rocking and rapping and spit like I be all into Megan Thee Stallion shit. Bruh, yes, I do. I like Megan, and I like the shit that she's talking about. She put it together well to me, even though whatever the fuck she's talking about, whether she's talking about fucking niggas and sucking dick, whatever the fuck, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just like how she put it together, and it makes sense, and I love how she grabbed, like, from the old music and pulling in, and she make it different and make it hers and stuff like that. You can tell she's fucking with Tori, because you see Tori, that's what Tori's me too.
She ruined that, that Eazy-E.
No, get out of here. I love that song.
Here's the thing. I'm from California.
Fuck that.
I feel like Saweetie should have never hopped on.
I love it.
Not ever. And then also, Meg should have just left it alone.
I mean,
mention the song.
I am sorry. But, you know, Lacey, no offense to you, because I personally feel like the difference of opinion that goes on here makes us the fucking truth session. You know what I'm saying? Like, we're not always supposed to agree with one another or anything like that. And so, like, I love how me and Lacey, like, we'll sit here and we'll go head, like, whatever, because I like this, and like, man, that shit whack, whatever, like that. But see, man, that's just, everybody have a right to their opinion, you know what I'm saying? And to me, the differences that we have is what makes the show, you know what I'm saying? That's what make it the truth session. And so, man, I just want to thank everybody who was tuned in tonight.
Thank you, Melo.
It's 10:03.
Thank you, Melo.
You know what I'm saying? It's 10:03, man. Whatever. Get Melo out of here, man. That shit lit. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out
to Megan Thee Stallion.
And
shout out to Mulatto. You know what I'm saying? Because we love Mulatto.
I love
everything that she's doing. And she's really on the rise. I mean, as a young female artist who is really out there, she's really doing her thing.
Yeah.
So, man, shout out to them. Shout out to Ace. Shout out to Wear Popa. Okay. Because we was calling the Papa all day. Shout out to Wear Popa. And shout out to my homie Ace. And shout out to the crew and everybody they brought along to come here and enjoy the true session with your girl Big Show and Lacey Dow. One more time, congratulations to Lacey Dow and to Freshie on their marriage. We wish you lifelong happiness. You know what I'm saying? All those great you know what I'm saying?
Where can we find you on social media?
That's right. We got to go out. Tell everybody again where they can find you, where they can find your music. We already know.
Ace Boom Coon MP3 on Instagram, Facebook, Quentin Simmons. That's me.
That's him.
Quentin Simmons.
Really?
If he adds you, that's him.
Expect a lot from us, you know.
I'll
be back on my sister's show.
Absolutely.
And she's going to grow with me.
Absolutely.
So we're going to grow together.
Absolutely.
I'm going to grow with Lacey, and I'm going to grow with y'all. We're going to grow together.
You know, let's love feminism.
Yeah. She's going to teach me all about feminism.
100. So, hey, look, man, y'all make sure y'all go right now. Y'all follow my bro, AZ Bukum. Follow him on the gram. Like he said, you can fucking Google him because he's the man. Like, as y'all saw, if y'all was on our live video feed, we got a legend. This is, they said, an Atlanta legend.
Definitely.
In the building. Yes. So y'all make sure that y'all supporting him. Make sure y'all supporting Rare Popo because he has a very, very significant message for our people with his brand. So y'all make sure y'all support him and y'all show love. And of course, man, make sure you tune in every Tuesday, 7 to 10. It's your girl Big Show and Lacey Dow.
Oh, wait, bro, got something to say. One more thing. Tonight we had Knockouts for Tankhead. My homeboy Tank here, he got some situation going on here in the hospital. So we're gonna be at Knockouts on Old National benefit concert. So I might do you. I forgot about that.
That's where he's gonna be at. He's gonna be at Knockouts.
Hey, what?
Where's Knockouts at?
Next time he said
where? Old National.
It's on Old National. Yeah, y'all, man, y'all get over to Knockouts on Old National. Y'all know what it is. Tonight. All right, so if you're looking for him, that's where you need to be. You heard me? Alright.
Yo, it's your girl Big Show. When you tuned in to the truth session, it don't get no realer than this.
You are now rocking with All Blacks Radio Atlanta, home of the $5 spin and your number one station for independent artists.
Truth session.
And we out.
Bye.
Damn.